Welcome to the Voice of Ocala on a beautiful Tuesday afternoon. See, I'm already trying to speed the week along. On a Tuesday afternoon, rain-free so far. Cross your fingers. It's about 135 degrees outside.
You just got that way, yes.
Nice day here at the Paddock Mall. Just got a little brighter.
Yes, I did, as I said.
Joe Martone joins us on a
Tuesday.
Strange Tuesday. Joe, I'm going to ask you.
Uh-oh.
Do you remember where Joe Martone was 20 years ago today?
That'd be what, 1994?
Four.
Yes, I was at Disney
June World. June 17th, 1994.
At Disney World, thank you very much.
About 7:30, 8 o'clock in the afternoon.
7:30, 8 o'clock in the evening.
The news broadcast all over the country broke in.
Yes.
To show us a white Ford Bronco in a slow speed chase on the Los Angeles freeway.
I remember that old Jay so well.
Orenthal James Simpson was a fugitive from justice in the back of a white Bronco owned by former teammate Al Cowling.
Yeah.
Supposedly with a gun to his head saying he was going to end it all. Just days after his ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and Ron Goldman had been found brutally murdered outside of her apartment in Los Angeles.
That was the slowest chase yet, about 40 miles an hour.
About 35, 40 miles an hour, with Al Cowling saying, he's going to shoot himself. Back off. Don't do it, OJ. Back off.
Yeah. How many was it? 14 cars behind him?
Oh, there was a ton of police cars behind him. And remember, people in Los Angeles, there were people stopping on the freeways and getting out on the overpasses and waving at OJ and everything as he went by.
Why did you remember the helicopter shot?
Let me explain something to you. The first reality television program ever.
That was it.
The OJ chase.
Yep.
It was reality TV.
And look at him now, right?
He's in prison now in Nevada. But
sick, supposedly.
But do you know that the OJ Simpson chase that was broadcast live on television?
Yeah.
Let me tell you the things that were going on that day. It was Arnold Palmer's a Friday of the U.S. Open. Arnold Palmer's last competitive U.S. Open.
It got preempted?
No, it happened same time. The Houston Rockets and New York Knicks were playing an NBA Finals Game 5. NBC was broadcasting the game, had split screen.
I remember the split
Bronco
screens
on the front,
yes,
and the basketball game on the bottom.
I remember that. I don't know why, but yes, now that you mention it, yeah.
The World Cup had just kicked off in Chicago. We had the World Cup here in 1994 in the USA. All these things were going on same day as O.J. Simpson, who, by the way, up until this point, was a beloved person in the United States.
Oh, yeah.
Beloved by Americans. Beloved by everybody. He had done the Hertz commercials where he was running through the
movies.
Airports. He did the Naked Gun movies, which he was great in.
That was hilarious.
Hilarious.
That was hilarious, yeah.
Did all those things. And then, and I remember where I was when I heard, I was driving, delivering pizzas.
Oh.
It was one of my summer jobs at Georgia Southern after I'd finished playing football when I was still trying to get my degree.
I wouldn't want to see you as a pizza delivery man. That's got to be a scary sight.
Well, I was actually the assistant manager, but I would pick up shifts delivering pizza because you got extra money that way.
I just say, here's your pizza, and your hand would go out and say.
And I'm delivering pizzas, and back then the only sports talk radio was 101 Sports. And 101 Sports. 27792. I remember 202-2792. Arnie Spanley would holler it at you.
Yeah, yeah.
That was the only, you know, sports. And they did a little update, and it said, breaking news out of Los Angeles, the former wife of O.J. Simpson, Buffalo Bills great O.J. Simpson, was found murdered in front of her apartment along with another person early this morning.
Yeah.
And that was it.
Oh, yeah, back to sports.
That was it. That was the blurb. Yeah. And I was like, that's peculiar. Poor OJ. His ex-wife got murdered like that.
Mm.
Wow, that's pretty bad.
Yeah, yeah. Then the glove doesn't fit.
Then they started looking into where was OJ. Then he had a taxi cab come pick him up. And there's a little-known story about this. Christopher Darden, who was the prosecuting attorney, the African-American that was the prosecuting attorney, for Los Angeles County. Mm-hmm. He wrote a book right after the trial. You know, everybody wrote a book. He wrote a book right after trial. Little known fact, O.J. Simpson was in Chicago when they found him. His son was in Fort Lauderdale. They both had been in L.A. the night of the murder.
Uh-oh.
Little known facts in Chris Darden's book. O.J.'s son had went to Fort Lauderdale and chartered a yacht, a sailing yacht.
Yeah.
O.J. had went to Chicago and then had tickets in Chicago to fly to Fort Lauderdale.
Huh.
I said the entire time when he said O.J. was the killer, I said, you're an idiot. O.J. did not kill those people. And I will stand by that to this day.
Who do you think did it?
O.J. had on, they made a big deal about his shoes had blood on it. But the only places the shoes had blood on it, they could find any blood, were three spots on the sole of the shoe.
Okay.
He almost could, the murderer, the person guilty of this murder, almost decapitated Nicole Brown Simpson.
Mm-hmm.
Stabbed Ron Goldman multiple times. And the only place you're going to find blood on his shoes that he's wearing during the murder is three spots on the sole?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. Thank you very much.
I thought all along, because it was well known in Hollywood circles and all, that O.J. Simpson's son did not like Nicole Brown Simpson.
But that much?
Hated her. Thought she was a gold digger who was just after his daddy for cash.
Hmm.
And here, months leading up to that murder, Nicole Brown Simpson would let other men, you know, younger men drive that Mercedes around that she was driving that O.J. was paying for.
Uh-huh.
And allegedly had, you know, men coming over to the house OJ's paying for. And I said the son sat there and watched it, and he was seething. This was, they say, the witness said they saw a male figure, 6 foot two, about 230 pounds, dash across the yard while the driver was there to pick OJ up. OJ said he was sleeping in the house. OJ had bad knees. There was no more dashing for OJ.
Yeah.
Okay.
After the Hertz commercial, that was
there. No more dashing for him. His middle 20 son, though,
could dash.
Get across the yard pretty easy. I always thought OJ had walked through the crime scene because his son come got him because it was right around the block. It wasn't like they lived a long way away.
Oh, okay.
So I think OJ walked through the crime scene and said, oh, hell, son, what have you done? And then they got this ill contrived out that they created. Because O.J.'s son went to Fort Lauderdale, and he was going to get on a yacht. Peace out.
Yeah, right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And O.J. was going with him. I firmly believe O.J. was going to go set him up in some non-extradition country somewhere, and he'd come back. And O.J. never worried about getting convicted because O.J. knew he didn't do it.
Yeah, the gloves didn't fit him, that's for sure.
And then Chris Darden made that mistake. Let him try the gloves on while he was wearing a latex glove and everything. And then Johnny Cochran said, if it doesn't fit, you must acquit.
Yeah.
And they did.
Yeah.
In what is the third most watched television news event in the history of the United States?
JFK's...
No.
No?
9/11 and Hurricane Katrina, 1-2.
Wow.
And then O.J. Simpson's white Bronco run.
Oh.
The third most watched live news event in the history of the country. Behind 9/11 and Hurricane Katrina, according to the Nielsen ratings.
Yeah, Hurricane Katrina, we went,
what does that
we went
say?
Through all that just before it happened.
Like, what does that say about who we are as a society? That the number three most watched live news event in the history of our country was the O.J. Simpson Bronco ride.
Well, yeah.
Here's the great thing.
But that's how many years apart?
Here's the funny thing. This young man sitting to your left, Christian, only knows about this because he's seen it on, you know, on TV and stuff like that.
He wasn't
5 years before he was here with us.
Yeah.
20 years ago today, O.J. Simpson took the infamous white Bronco ride.
I remember so well.
On the interstate, on the freeway system, and the streets of L.A. And the people of L.A. stood out and clapped and cheered, standing on the road going, juice, 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 cheering for O.J. Simpson. It was the most surreal thing I'd ever witnessed in my life. And the thing is, glued to the television.
Oh, yeah, sure.
I was working at the time. It was, like I said, it was my summer job delivering pizzas. I was also, my buddy had a convenience store. And so I would fill in on Fridays and Saturdays, took the night shift on Friday and Saturday nights, because I didn't go out till about midnight, so I could work till 10 o'clock, didn't bother me.
Yeah.
And I sat there, and he had a little TV in the store, and I watched that Bronco chase. Or, I don't really want to call it a chase, because it wasn't a chase.
It was just a summer drive.
Yeah, it was. It was like driving Mr. Daisy.
What did it take, about 2 hours? Was that about 2 hours?
About two and a half hours.
Yeah. Oh, boy, look, we're watching a car go down the road. With a bunch of squad cars behind it.
A bunch of squad cars and news helicopters and police helicopters everywhere.
I know. I was surprised they didn't collide.
20 years ago today. Hey, we're going to take a break. When we come back.
What are we doing?
Trivianator Tuesday with Tom. Your chance to win. Today, Joe, I got great gifts today. How about this?
I see that.
My first thing I'm giving away is two tickets to the Ocala Comic Con and a free meal at Dairy Queen.
No,
PDQ. Where's that? Oh, that's Tim Tebow's restaurant.
There you go.
Wow.
Before it opens.
That's before it opens.
That's before it opens. Our listeners are getting it. That's on June 20th.
That's this Friday.
Yes, it is.
From 5:30 to 6 p.m., you got to go through the drive-thru.
And you get whatever. It's up to two people in the car.
Yeah.
You get what
two
you want.
People, and it's a free meal.
Yes.
Between just go through the drive-thru. You're going to help them train.
Yes, exactly.
So we're doing it at PDQ. I seen DQ and I thought
it was
DQ. PDQ, that's PDQ fresh tender salads and sandwiches.
We're trying to get Tim Tebow on the air with us. I'm going to see that.
Tim Tebow's restaurant. I'm going to give you two free meals is what you can get.
Exactly.
Plus two tickets to the Ocala Comic Con coming up next weekend. Not this weekend, but the following weekend
Those
at the Ocala Hilton.
Those are worth $15 each.
Right. They're single-day passes.
Exactly.
So you can either go by yourself 2 days in a row and have two meals right here. You can put one in the refrigerator, or you can be nice and take somebody with you.
Oh, that would be nice.
We'll try to give one of those away next on Trivianator Tuesday with Tom, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're streaming live at WOCA.com.
The source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on the Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Hey, Eddie, I'm playing Augusta in a few hours, and I need a fourth. Want to join us?
Georgia's close, but it's not that close, Alex.
Not Georgia. Golden Ocala. I'm a member at Golden Ocala, and this course has 8 tribute holes, like number 12 and 13. You know, part of Amen Corner and the postage stamp and the road hole. It's a phenomenal track. My family and I always have a great time at the pool and at the restaurants. They've got 3, you know. The kids love the tennis programs. My wife practically lives at the spa, and I've been bulking up with a personal trainer in their fitness center. Joining Golden Ocala was one of the best decisions I've ever made, aside from marrying my wife, of course. So you want to join us in a few hours?
Absolutely. I can't wait to play the first hole in golf and the road hole too. Hey, how do I become a member at Golden Ocala?
Eddie, just call 352-402-4343.
Luxury and great golf is affordable at Golden Ocala. Call 352-402-4343 to join.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphare. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
This is the Salvation Army, and I'm Major George Patterson to let you know that the Salvation Army is available 24 hours a day to provide help to anyone. We also have a family store at 120 Northwest 10th Street in Ocala. On Tuesday to Saturday from 9 to 4, you can do your shopping. Or if you want to donate, you can call 352-732-4469 and we'll even pick up. 352-732-4469. All funds generated by our store go into the programs here in Marion County to help the needy.
On the next day of Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Bond, Mike Bond. He's an award-winning poet and a human rights correspondent, and he's with the BBC coming out to speak to us about his book, House of Jaguar. It's a thriller novel based on Mike Bond's own experiences in Guatemala.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Brad Nimmo will be in the studio. He's the president and CEO of Habitat for Humanity of Marion County. He's coming in with Sarah Isaacs. They'll be talking to us about the Mud Volleyball Tournament Bump, Set, and Build fundraising event.
Have all of your legal questions answered by Attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Harlem Globetrotter Buckets Blakes is coming on the air with us, celebrating the 89th consecutive year of the Harlem Globetrotters.
Jay Scott is the co-executive director of Alex's Lemonade Stand Foundation. He'll be speaking about the foundation dedicated to finding a cure for childhood cancer.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Don't get caught without your daily source of senior deals. Pick up your copy of the Senior Voice newspaper. It's your source for schedule and events tailored to seniors with information you need, like a list of free events in the area. We even have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company to you that fits your needs. And all we ask in return is that you tell them where you heard about them. For more information, call Tom's Picks, 352-804-1223. And pick up your copy of the Senior's Voice at most any business up and down the 200 corridor.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
We're back.
Yeah, we are. I went to press music and pressed the X instead of music. So.
Well, so we have X music?
Yeah, we have X music.
That means no music.
No music, exactly.
That's why it didn't come up.
It is Trivinator Tuesday with Tom, however, though.
That's true.
We do have an open phone line, 622-9622. Is that still the Climate Control Source Hotline?
So far, so good.
Climate Control Source Hotline. Give a trivia question out there. Today, we're giving away, Joe, we're giving away a pretty good prize pack today.
Yes.
Ocala Comic Con tickets.
Yeah, 28th and 29th.
Hilton of Ocala, 28th or 29th. These tickets are good for one. You can use them.
One or the other.
One or the other day. It's not for the whole. It's a $15 ticket.
That's going to be at the Hilton right here in Ocala.
Plus, this is a big deal. You're invited to come enjoy a meal on us and help our training team teach perfect execution in our new location. PDQ Ocala. That's the restaurant that Tim Tebow's part owner in.
That's right.
And
WOCA is proud to be involved with everything in this community.
This invitation is good for two guests going through the drive-thru. So this is, you get two meals and two tickets to Ocala Comic Con.
That's it. That's not bad.
All you got to do is answer two questions. It's two. Everything is two here.
Can I answer the questions or not?
No, you're not eligible.
Dang it all.
You're not eligible. Much as I'd like you to be eligible.
Yeah.
I really wouldn't like you to be
eligible. I probably wouldn't have the answer anyway.
Well,
I'll write it down and show you.
You may have the answer, but you wouldn't be eligible. But
that's true.
You may have the answer. I don't know. Yeah, you could have the answer.
Yeah.
Of course, you don't even know what the question is, do you?
Saturday.
That is not the answer.
Dang it all.
I know. What are you going to do, though?
I tried.
You did try. Yeah. Here's the first question on Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. Who starred along Meryl Streep and Steve Martin in the 2009 movie It's Complicated? Who starred alongside Meryl Streep and Steve Martin in the 2009 movie It's Complicated? If you know the answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win an invitation to go to PDQ for two guests to enjoy a meal on them and two tickets to the Ocala Comic Con. All you got to do is answer who starred alongside Meryl Streep and Steve Martin in the 2009 movie It's Complicated. You answer that one, I ask you a follow-up question. You get that right? You're a winner. It's that easy, Joe. Now, you know this answer, don't you?
I don't know. Is that the answer, Tom?
That is not the answer.
I guess I don't know the answer, then.
No, you really have no idea.
I have no idea, do I know?
This is not unfettered territory for you, though.
No, but I just...
Not having any idea.
Oh, I thought it was a movie. I didn't see the movie.
Oh, I see. Well, we got a caller. Let's see who our caller.
Okay.
Let's see what our caller
decides.
Let's see
how smart they are.
Hi, caller. Who's this?
Hi. Is it Alec Baldwin?
But who's this, please? What's your name?
Linda.
Hi, Linda.
I called in about a SpongeBob question.
It is Alec Baldwin. You're pretty good at these TV and movie stuff, Linda.
I'm not looking them up either.
Now, let's go. If you get this second one right, you will win two tickets.
Again.
Two tickets to Ocala Comic Con and two dinners at PDQ. What is the name of the Grinch's dog in the movie? How the Grinch Stole Christmas?
The Grinch's dog in the movie?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's also the Grinch's dog in the cartoon that's on TV, too. You got 5 seconds.
I don't know.
2 seconds. Come up with a guess.
I can't believe I got through. I got 2 seconds. Max?
Oh, you're kidding.
Max is correct.
Oh, you're kidding me.
Max is correct.
I got it. Uh-huh. So I won two tickets to the Comic-Con?
Yeah, you won two tickets to the Ocala Comic-Con and two dinners to PDQ Fresh Tender Salads and Sandwiches, the new restaurant opening here on a 200 that's owned by Tim, that's part owned by Tim Tebow.
Okay.
So,
how do I redeem my promise?
Linda, what's your the first letter of your last name?
M.
Linda M. Come by the WOCA studios. They'll be here for you to pick up tomorrow morning at 9:00.
Okay, tomorrow morning. And
yep.
Where is that studio?
We're located at the Paddock Mall, right in front of the food court entrance.
That's right.
Thanks so much for playing Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom. Have a great day.
Thank you. Bye.
So see, just that easy.
Easy.
Linda wins something. Just that easy.
She caught that right under the wire.
Right, I mean, I was going to ding her out and say that she was done.
Ding, Max.
Max, come on. There you go. So it's that easy, Joe, to play Trivia Night Tuesday.
Well, if you have the answers.
Well, you got to have the answers.
You know. You have anything else? You going to do it again later?
I'm going to do it right now, as a matter of fact.
What else do you have?
See, this is really, I'm really giving away too much here.
No, you got to. $20 gift. Keep it home, put it in a safe? Nah, give it away.
$20 gift. We'll give it away after the break. We'll ask the question after the break.
We'll ask about a minute and a half. Okay, so we're just going to tell
them
what they have.
But it's what I'm
going to give away.
I'm going to give away a $20 gift certificate worth of plants. $20 worth of plants.
From
Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens.
Ooh, okay.
I'm going to give you two more dinners from PDQ.
The drive-thru. Okay.
And then I'm going to give you $10 in Mojo's gift card.
Wait a minute, how did that slip by me?
I may be giving it too much away.
That's good enough. That's
about $80 right there.
It's good. What's wrong with that?
Wow.
What's wrong with that?
We may be giving too much away.
No, never. It's never too much.
We'll ask the question as we go out to break, and that way you'll have plenty of time to Google.
Check it.
See if you're right. See if you're right.
Well, it's the second question to get some time.
So, Joe.
Yes.
Lawyers get a bad rap, right?
Well, yeah, they get sometimes. They do, yeah.
Well, in 2003, and again this spring, a Bartow lawyer has told a federal judge in court on the record that people are torturing her through a microchip illegally placed in her head.
This is a lawyer?
Yeah. The Janice L. Jennings told the judge that opposing counsel John W. Campbell has used special technology to make her miss the court date. So the judge asked on the record, you're saying something is implanted in your brain. She says, in the air of my left ear, Jennings responded. And the judge said, you're saying Mr. Campbell, your opposing counsel, used a device to somehow subject you to torture? Her answer was, I believe so. He called her accusations bizarre, and the second federal judge called it peculiar. The federal bar has opened an inquiry, and a nonprofit group that helps lawyers cope with mental illness has reached out to Jennings.
It's called a hearing aid. That's her problem. It's located by her ear. Tune out the hearing aid.
Wow. You know, not to make light that the lady has some mental issues, but a judge in court. I missed court yesterday because the opposing counsel has implanted a chip in my ear to make me miss court.
Check the hearing aid. See about that. Yeah.
Check something. Check something.
Something's not right. Yeah.
This is the second time, 2003, and now again this spring. I don't know about that. Hey, coming up next, Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom. The question I'm going to ask right now. What waterway built in the early 1800s helped the trade routes from the Great Lakes to Hudson Bay? Tell me that answer coming up. right here on The Source.
Bring me down. Can't none of you. Bring me down.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of the Properties Salon in downtown Ocala. Here in Florida, we're all about summertime fun, but along with the warm weather comes humidity, which leads to the dreaded frizzies. Are you tired of checking the weather report every morning before deciding to flat iron your hair? Sick of looking like the Lion King every day by noon? Has God just not seen fit to answer your prayers for patience and silky, frizz-free hair? Well, your troubles are over. Come to the Properties Salon for one of our hair smoothing systems. Specializing in Peter Coppola and Cezanne keratin smoothing treatments, the Properties Salon can tame your unruly locks with these formaldehyde-free formulas. And with the discount code BUDDYROCKS, you will save 20%. Not fighting the frizzies? Mention the same code BUDDYROCKS to save 20% off one of our many services such as cuts, color extensions, and manis and pedis. Gentlemen, this special is not just for the ladies. We do great cuts and color for men too. Check us out at theproperties.com for more information.
It's the ultimate summer staycation, just minutes from downtown Ocala, but miles away from the ordinary. A summer sports or summer golf membership at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club is your all-inclusive ticket to a summer filled with activities and fun from June through September. A summer membership at Golden Ocala opens the door to a world-class setting. Is golf your game? Is tennis your passion? Or is lounging poolside more your speed? Want to get in shape? Work out in the state-of-the-art fitness center and then relax and unwind in the sauna or the spa. Summer members also have use of the Equestrian Center at Golden Ocala, offering full board and paddock, impeccable trails, and a jumping ring for riders of all ages. Summer memberships are going fast, so visit goldenocala.com and explore the options. Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. This summer, you can live there and still play here.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. In American custody now, a key suspect in the 2012 Benghazi attack, which left four Americans dead. The president saying he wants the world to know.
When Americans are attacked, no matter how long it takes, we will find those responsible, and we will bring them to justice.
Speaking in Pittsburgh a short while ago.
President Obama approved the mission to capture Ahmed Abu Qatala on Friday night. Over the weekend, U.S. Special Forces and the FBI captured the notorious Islamist commander in a secret raid south of Benghazi, Libya.
Fox Radio's Rachel Sutherland. The IRS has lost more emails connected to the Tea Party investigation. Congressional investigators saying today they were told it happened when computers of six workers crashed. This on top of losses from the crash of Lois Lerner's computer revealed on Friday. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At Termbusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call Termbusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco.
Hey Adam, those burgers gonna be done before summer's over?
Maybe. Why? You got big plans for the summer?
Not really. Just the usual, kids hanging around the house. How about you?
Actually, I'm having Joshua get his pilot's license this summer.
What? Is he old enough? Can you really do that in just the summer?
Yeah, you can get your pilot's license at 17, and the summer is plenty of time. Plus, this could be the start to his career as an airline pilot.
That is a great idea. I bet Tyler would love that. Actually, I would too.
You guys should do it.
I don't have time for that. Some of us have to work for a living, you know?
Not you, no. Seriously, they work work around your schedule.
Really? That's cool. Where are you going?
Ocala Aviation, at the airport off 60th.
How'd you hear about it?
I heard about it on the radio, then I stopped in. I've got a card if you want the number.
Yeah, hold on. Let me get my phone.
Hurry up. The burgers are burning.
Okay, I'm ready. Go ahead.
861-7484.
Hold on. I missed a number.
Ah, such a slacker. Here it is again. 861-7484.
Excellent. I'm going to call them now.
How about we eat before you start your new adventure?
That's probably a good idea.
You think?
Hello, gorgeous.
Hi, this is Becky at Hello Gorgeous Salon. We are located in the heart of downtown Ocala, right next to the historic Marion Theater. I'd like to invite you to stop by and see our new boutique area and meet our staff of professional stylists. Here at Hello Gorgeous, we are ready to update your look with the latest trends. And with summer here, it's the perfect time to brighten up your look. So make your appointment now for those highlights and Brazilian blowout. But don't stop there. We are a full-service salon offering manicures, pedicures, and facials also. So if you've been searching for a salon to call your own, come and see us at Hello Gorgeous Salon. We are located at 48 South Magnolia Avenue in downtown Ocala, right next to the Marion Theater. So call today and set up your appointment at Hello Gorgeous Salon at 351-5358. That's 351-5358. And don't forget, we also do men and children's cuts too. 351-5358.
Hello Gorgeous.
You know, that movie comes out this Friday.
Jersey Boys.
Jersey Boys.
Oh, yeah.
Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons.
I might go see that. I don't.
You know where it's going to be playing?
Where? Right here?
The historic Marion Theater.
Is it? Oh.
I may know a guy that can get you in there pretty cheap.
All right. I like that price.
It's a pretty good price.
Can I bring Patsy?
Uh-oh. Guess who's calling us? Kathy Cole is calling us, Joe.
Why? What did you do wrong now?
I don't know, Kathy Cole. She always calls to get me in trouble. Kathy, how are you today? Kathy, are you there? Wait, let me do the line. Kathy's on.
That would help.
Maybe if I push the line up, Kathy's on. Hi, Kathy. How are you?
Hi. Hello. Hi. Can you hear me now?
I just had to push the right right line, Kathy.
I know this answer without Googling, I think.
Okay. The question is, what waterway built in the early 1800s helped route from the Great Lakes to Hudson Bay?
The Erie Canal?
The Erie Canal. That is correct. That is correct. All right. Now, if you know this next question, you'll win a $10 gift card to Mojo's, two meals from PDQ, and a $20 gift certificate from Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens. Are you ready?
Wow. I'm ready.
Uh-oh.
All right. Here we go. What was the Allies' password on D-Day?
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, she's not going to get this
Allies.
One.
What was the Allies' password on D-Day? 5 seconds.
5 seconds. My goodness. Let me think of it.
All right.
Let me think.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, give me a minute.
Okay. Can't do that, Kathy. You know you're trying. We know you're trying, Kathy, but yeah. Just didn't come to you. Hey, Kathy, let me ask something. Where were you 20 years ago today when the O.J. Simpson Bronco ride took place?
I think I was just home watching it on TV. I did watch it on TV.
You and a bunch of other Americans watching on TV, Kathy.
Right. Yeah, that was amazing, wasn't it?
It was something. I'll give you that.
Yeah, the word amazing exactly. I don't think fits, but yeah.
Kathy, thanks for playing Terminator Tuesday
Thank
with Tom.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Hey.
All right. All so right. The question is, what was the password the Allies used on D-Day?
Attack.
It was not attack.
No.
It's a very hard question.
It's a very hard question?
It's a hard question. And unless you're from somewhere in the state of Florida, then it's probably pretty easy. Or if you're Joe Mart's owner, Tom Schmitz, and it is part of the iconic part of one of your favorite places on earth.
Disney World, Disneyland.
Hey, thanks for calling Trivia Tuesday with Tom. Who's this?
This is Pete.
It's Pete?
Yeah, uh-oh.
This is Pete, yeah.
Okay. I'm in trouble now, Joe, because Pete knows the answer. You know that. You know Pete knows everything.
Okay. Mickey Mouse.
Pete, right. What is the Allies' password on D-Day?
Flash Thunder.
It was not Flash Thunder.
What?
That was not the password on D-Day.
Splash Mountain. No,
okay.
Was it?
You got me.
Thanks for calling.
Oh, wasn't that?
Hugh, how are you today, buddy?
Oh, pretty good. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing well. What was the password that the Allies used on D-Day?
I just a wild guess. Was it Overlord?
Overlord was the name of the operation. That was not the password.
Okay, I gave it a try.
That was not Hugh. Did you watch the infamous O.J. Simpson Bronco ride 20 years ago?
The wife and I were in a Chinese restaurant, and we were waiting to get seated. We were in a bar area that had a large TV going on, and we're waiting for it to be seated. And we watched. We told the waiter, the people there, that we wanted a table that was close to this area so we could watch. And we sat there and ate our Chinese dinner, watching this thing going on.
Hugh, I don't believe I'd have told people that, Hugh. Hey, thanks for playing, Hugh.
Okay.
Have a good day.
10 minutes, it didn't change anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Hi, caller. Who's this?
My name is Chris Arney.
Hi, Chris. How are you today?
I'm doing good.
Chris, what was the Allies' password on D-Day?
Is it Mickey Mouse?
It was Mickey Mouse. That is correct.
Who said that earlier?
I believe you did, Joe. Yeah. Giving away answers. I don't know, they still didn't get it.
What are you going to do?
All right. Now, if you get this second question right, you'll win a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill, PDQ, two meals, PDQ, and Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens.
Yeah, turn your radio down a little bit.
Turn your radio down for us a little bit, please.
I can't hear it.
We can hear it.
We can hear it. Turn it down, please.
What?
We can hear it. It feeds back on the air. It's not good to have your radio up. It feeds back on the air.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Listen to us on the phone.
All right, here we go. Who was the first guest host of Saturday Night Live?
Oh, my goodness.
Who was the first guest host of Saturday Night Live?
First guest host. Wow. Now I've got to think.
5 seconds. Five, four. Three.
Chevy
Chase was not correct. Oh. Hey, thanks for playing, Chris. Have a great day.
You too.
Wow.
So who was the first guest host?
Do we get a hint? Is it male or female?
It's a guy. It was a guy.
It was the guy.
Who was the first guest host of Saturday Night Live?
Oh, man, I can't guess. So.
No, you can't guess.
How about that? Is that the right one?
No, it's not right.
Oh, okay.
It's not right.
Oh, okay.
So. Not right. So,
was he a celebrity?
Was a celebrity. Oh yeah.
Or he still is a celebrity? Still,
no longer with us. See, I gave you another hint there.
That's what I'm shooting. I'm trying to help the listeners.
He's trying to help him out.
So
a 70-year-old man calls 911, Joe.
Yes.
In Orlando,
about
12:30 p.m. Last Friday afternoon.
Uh-huh.
Police show up. They see him sitting on the tailgate of his truck. Gunshot wound.
Where?
To his right foot.
A hot dog. And?
Well, it seems he was approaching his truck. He had his gun in its holster.
Oh, that kind of gun.
The holster was broke. The gun fell out of his waistband, hit his foot, and discharged. He shot his own self in the foot because he couldn't hold his gun.
Oh, you hold your liquor, can't hold your gun. What can I say?
The round then ricocheted into the front grill area of a 2009 beige Dodge Charger, causing about $1,000 worth of damage. The car was not occupied at the time. Williams was taken to the hospital, and his gun was returned later to him that day.
I hope he bought a new holster.
He accidentally shot himself in the foot in the parking lot of Winn-Dixie because his holster recently broke and he was carrying his concealed weapon in his waistband. I never understood those guys. You'd see those 70s private eye shows where they'd put the gun in their waistband.
I'm sorry.
That's aimed at the wrong area for me to be putting it in my waistband. I'm just telling you.
Those are the guys that don't have a relation, so they don't have to worry about it.
You know, I never, like Plexico Burris, the Pittsburgh Steeler and New York Giant, that shot himself in the thigh in a New York nightclub.
Because
he dropped the gun that he was holding in his waistband of his sweatpants.
Oh, that's smart. That's smart.
Yeah, he ended up going to prison for 2 years for that. Shooting his own self in the leg, got 2 years in prison.
We got good health benefits.
See, I'm for gun control when it's like that. Know how to control your own weapon so you don't shoot yourself.
Gun control is not missing your target. That's no. Gun control.
You know, know how to control your own firearm so it doesn't fall through your pants and shoot you in the leg.
I know. They give you gun training, but not how to carry the gun, I guess.
Goodness.
Great. Well, it broke, so I put it on. No.
Tune in Tuesday with Tom. The question out there now, I've already forgot what the question was.
The question was? You remember the question, Chris?
Oh, I do.
Oh, okay.
Who was the first guest host of Saturday Night Live?
Let's see.
If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win. That is correct, sir. For your chance to win,
I did
a $10 movie, $10 gift card to Mojo's, two meals from PDQ right here. PDQ Ocala is about to open up right here on College Road.
Yeah,
it's where the old Lone Star was. They destroyed the Lone Star and put this in there.
About 130 seats.
They want you to come enjoy a meal on them. Help their training team. We got a caller. Let's see who we got, Joe.
Yes.
Hi, caller. Who's this?
Ron.
Hi, Ron. How are you today?
Good. How are you,
Ron? Where were you when O.J. Simpson decided to take that low speed chase through the freeway system of L.A.?
I was probably driving a truck.
So you weren't watching it then?
No.
Good for you, Ron. Way not to fall victim to just salacious television. Hi, Ron. Who was the first guest host of Saturday Night Live?
I'm going to guess. I'm going to say Richard Pryor.
Richard Pryor was not getting right, but you're in the right genre.
Yes, right. Yeah. Okay.
You're in the right genre. Hey, thanks for playing Trivia Tuesday with Tom.
Can I give him a hint?
No.
Oh, come on.
But I will tell you this. It's a person known for giving you the seven things you can never say on television.
That's the hint I was going to give. Okay.
That's all I'm telling you.
That's the same hint I was going to give.
One of the funniest bits you will ever hear in your life.
Yeah, I was going to give that hint. Okay, fine.
Who was the first guest host of Saturday Night Live? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline. 622-9622 for your chance to win quite a bit.
I know. $10 Mojos. Let's see. What else did you have over there?
PDQ.
And a $20 gift card to Bob Wine's
Community Garden. We got about 25 seconds, so we get one more caller here.
Let's see.
See if we can get one more caller trying to figure out who was the first guest host.
Yeah, you can Google this if you want. It's the second
Saturday Night Live. If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline. 622-9622. We got a caller right here on the Climate Control Source Hotline. Last caller today. Hi, caller. Who's this?
CJ.
Hey, CJ. What's up, buddy? Long time no talk.
Yeah.
CJ, who was the first guest host of Saturday Night Live?
George Carlin.
Yeah. George Carlin is correct.
All right. That's one.
All right,
though.
CJ, if you know this answer here, you'll win a $10 gift card to Mojo's, two meals from PDQ Ocala, and a $20 gift certificate to Bob Wines. Okay, ready?
I'm ready.
According to NASA, how many meteorites hit the Earth every year? Is it 100, 500, or 1,000? According to NASA, how many meteorites hit the Earth every year? 100, 500, or 1,000?
1,000.
Oh, sorry. That is not correct.
Whoa.
Hey, CJ, thanks for playing Trivia Dead Tuesday with Tom.
Yeah, buddy, see ya.
So that wraps up Trivia Dead Tuesday with Tom. The correct answer? 500, NASA say, hits the Earth every year.
That's all. I figured
500 meteorites hit the Earth every year.
1,000 too.
We're going to take a break. When we come back, I'll tell Joe about a guy in Sunrise that says, I was just kidding. It was a joke. Wait till you hear what this moron tried to say the joke was. Right here on Trivia Tuesday with Tom on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're streaming live because we're live and local on The Source. Regions Bank has big bank ability, but possesses small bank agility. Utilizing tools like Raymond Andrews and his team of six mortgage experts with 100 years of experience in the mortgage industry and 50 years experience as members of the Regions Bank team. Mortgage lending is personal and important. and you deserve someone that will lead you through a positive process. Raymond and his team use local mortgaging processes like local appraisers and local closing to help you have a positive experience, and they habla Espanol as well. So whether you need a conventional, FHA, USDA, or VA loan, or you even need a construction loan, the mortgage team of your local Regions Bank has the knowledge and experience to guide you through the process. So contact Raymond Andrews and his team of mortgage experts at 352-854-4104. That's 352-854-4104. Regions Bank, it's time to expect more.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Veterans are the foundation upon which our freedom is built. Listen to The Source, WOCA, each Thursday at 9 a.m. to Veterans News with Hank Whittier from Vets Helping Vets. You'll hear tributes, information on veterans' issues, and stories that will make you laugh, cry, and feel proud. Veterans News always focuses on the military, past and present, and on our first responders. Veterans News is brought to you each week by Palm Chevrolet, where supporting the community is the Palm Chevy way, and by Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens and Nursery, keeping you blooming since 1952.
The weather's brought to you by myfwc.com. Life jackets save lives. We're at Florida. We have a mix of sun and clouds today with a couple of thunderstorms around in the afternoon and evening. High 87 to 91. Tonight will be partly cloudy. Low 69 to 73. Tomorrow will feature partly sunny skies with a thunderstorm spots in the afternoon. High 86 to 90. And it looks like we'll have a thunderstorm spots tomorrow evening. Otherwise, partly cloudy. Low 70 to 72. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Stephanie Omo.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
Men, do you know your testosterone level? Are you experiencing decreased energy levels or unusual sleeping problems? Have you noticed you have less strength or endurance, decreased sex drive, increased irritability or depression? If so, you may be experiencing problems with low testosterone. If you're interested in a free testosterone screening, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. Again, that number is 352-629-5800.
Turn the mics on, then we'll welcome back. Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala.
See, now, if you didn't tell anybody, no one would have known you, boo-boo.
Well, I know. What are you going to do, though? I can't wait for this movie to come out.
Clint Eastwood directed it. 84 years old.
Yep, the Jersey Boys. You heard great things about the musical.
Yeah.
And so now the movie's coming out. Starts this Friday. We'll be at the Marion Theater.
And actually shot on some of the locations that
actually
happened.
Right, exactly. That's so, what I mean. Yeah. So, yes. Christopher Walken's in it. Any movie that has Christopher Walken in it, you got to go see.
I can't do a Christopher Walken.
Buddy Martin joins us an hour or two on the show today. Buddy, Buddy's going to talk about five things you may not have known about Marilyn Monroe. Plus, Dr. Oz, is he in hot water?
What did he do now?
I don't know. We'll find out when Buddy gets here. Plus, it's Fake or Factoid, quickly becoming the most popular game in America.
In America?
In America.
And who's going to copy it?
Everybody. Hey. That's you know,
you get
everybody,
a copyright against,
everybody copies.
So they want it. Oh, you got to pay us something.
So have you ever said, just kidding. I was joking. Didn't mean it.
Uh-huh.
You ever done that? You ever said that?
Well, yeah. It depends. If you got two guys talking about something and the girl said, what?
Well, a Sunrise man told police he was only joking.
Sunrise man.
Sunrise, Florida.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Told the police, I'm joking.
I forget. What did he do?
Police said, really? That's what you're going with? You're joking? He said, yeah, I was only joking when I tried to ignite the gasoline that I'd accidentally spilled on my wife while she was in bed.
Oh!
He was charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon without the intent to kill.
Oh, like, yeah?
In court Monday, the woman who he soaked in gas and tried to light on fire cried and begged the judge to let him out because he's a great guy, a good husband, and a father.
Was she asleep at the time? Or somebody hit her in the head with
a judge club. The judge told the wife, we have no doubt that if the lighter hadn't been empty and it would have ignited, you wouldn't be here right now to tell us how great a guy he is.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Yeah. At least they have sleepwalking.
Kimraj Samlal, 43, was charged with aggravated assault. Him and his wife had argued early Sunday morning when he came home drunk after a night out with friends. She told him he was a bad father for not spending time with their daughter and son on Father's Day. A maintenance worker accused his pointed two knives at his wife, threatened to kill her. The son saw his father get a red gas can from the backyard, bring it in the house, throw the fuel on his wife, and then try to light her on fire.
What was she doing while he was doing this?
But the lighter wouldn't ignite, so then he tried to get the knives out. The son called the police.
Oh, well, thank goodness. See, now, if he was a smart man, he would have just touched the lighter to it.
Let me tell you, you know who's smart? The judge. He set his bail at $1 million.
Good. See you later, alligator. Yeah.
So, see, what happened was I accidentally tripped and the gas can poured out on my wife while she was in the bed. I was just joking. I didn't mean to set her on fire.
Right. What was the cigarette lighter excuse? I wanted to see if it worked.
Anything that starts with "see what happened was" is never a good thing.
It's a simple. I wanted to see if the guarantee was still
there. You go. Hey, coming up hour two, Buddy Martin joins the show. Faker Factoid plus five things you didn't know about Marilyn Monroe. All that coming up on The Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Just know you're not alone, because I'm going to make this place your home.
Are you a business owner looking for a new and innovative way to reach consumers by thinking outside of the box? Well, here's a great new idea that thinks inside the box. Value Box. Value Box is a beautiful recipe box that features your business's profile on the front of recipe cards with a personal recipe on the back. With Value Box, a business's name can stay in front of their customers for years. They also offer an app for your iPhone or iPad for those who cook in the 21st century. So if it's time for your business to think outside the box to reach consumers, start by thinking inside the box with Value Box. For more information, you can contact Chuck Henderson of Value Box USA at 352-433-5301. That's 352-433-5301. Or by email, chuck@valueboxusa.com.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day, whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands. At Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Hi,
I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, the new old-fashioned bank. Let us introduce you to Okus, a simple way to bring your business online. Through this relationship, your business can have a fully functioning website in less than 30 minutes. We will also provide you support with social media, sales tracking, e-commerce, and online scheduling, which is all optimized for mobile users. Okus, now at Gateway Bank, Silver Springs Boulevard, Ocala. Come visit our technology center for your total small business solution. I'm Tom Ingram, and I'll see you there.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
When you kiss somebody for the first time, you subconsciously decipher a whole host of information about their health and your compatibility. Workers who scheduled a day off every few weeks saw their productivity increase to fresh off their vacation levels. Turns out, just seeing a strong-willed person stick to their goals, even in the face of temptation, increases your own motivation.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Coming August 8th and 9th, the first annual Ocala Bike Fest. How would you like a chance to win a 2014 Harley Street Glide? How about a 2014 Indian Chief Vintage? The tickets are only $100 each, and each chance drawing has only 599 tickets. Now that is some great odds. All proceeds go to ARC. Questions, call 387-2210. The number again is 387-2210. Ocala Bike Fest. We'll see you there.
Ocala Comic Con, June 28th and 29th. Ocala Comic Con, the place to Hilton in Ocala. Ocala Comic Con, over 100 vendors and artists. Ocala Comic Con, costume contest. Ocala Comic Con, daily raffle. Ocala Comic Con, Pokemon XY tournament. Ocala Comic Con, June 28th and 29th. Ocala Comic Con, www.ocalacomiccon.com. Ocala Comic Con, special guests. Ocala Comic Con.
Are you tired of not using your home's outdoor space for entertaining or relaxation because of all the bugs and leaves? Consider adding a beautiful screen room or glass enclosure. We are Superior Aluminum and Design, a family-owned and operated business with 20 years' experience in the aluminum industry, and we are accredited by the Better Business Bureau. If you appreciate superior workmanship, call Superior Aluminum and Design at 817-8058 or visit us on the web at superioraluminumdesign.com.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler.
Regardless of how long it takes, we will find you.
The president on Sunday's capture near Benghazi of a key suspect in the consulate attack that killed four Americans. The suspect now on a Navy ship in international waters.
A intelligence interrogation team has been working with the suspect, Ahmed Abu Katala. When they feel there's no more intelligence that they can get, they will then Mirandize him and pass him off to an FBI team that will then interrogate him for a potential trial in the U.S. And he, we've now learned, will be brought back to a U.S. District Court in Washington, D.C.
Fox's Jennifer Griffin. The National Weather Service says four powerful tornadoes hit Pilgrim, Nebraska yesterday. Two people killed. Charges dropped against singer Paul Simon and wife Edie Brickell, the couple arrested in April after an altercation at their home. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available available for you as well. At Termbusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call Termbusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind, because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone? He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Buddy Martin, I'm following up the act of Tom and Joe, which will soon be on the road, I believe, somewhere. Who knows where?
That was almost like Lewis and
it
Martin.
Was.
I was, of course, Martin, I think.
You were?
Was I the straight guy or was Joe? I don't know. You never know.
I think you might have been something, called something else.
I might have been Lewis.
Yeah.
Okay.
Might have called it. I'm not sure you'd call either. But you know, by the way, they were funny at one time. People thought.
Oh,
that,
Martin and Lewis were hilarious at one
absolutely,
time.
Absolutely. So
Crosby and Hope were hilarious together.
So I'm watching a little bit of soccer.
I watched the game last night.
I watched the game. It was turned out to be an exciting game, which we know the Americans won over Ghana. And boy, there was a lot of Americans that went down, got hurt. Altidore got hurt off the bat, maybe out for how long? But
bad
anyway,
strained.
Yeah, and so there have been a lot of injuries in soccer. But so I'm watching. I have this newfound enthusiasm. I'm trying to commit.
Comes up every 4 years during the World Cup.
Watch some, and I have watched a little bit. But I got a couple issues with it, you know. I just have to – and most people today think it's so hip, they don't want to say anything that might be construed to be negative about soccer. And I'm not saying it's negative.
Flopping is negative, buddy.
But they're flopping the NBA, too. But the deal is – that if you don't grasp it with the same passion that a soccer player does, then you just don't get it. And in a way, it's like a football fan. And we'll discuss this in the Sports Hour with Dave Pingelore and Tom James around the water cooler today. And if an SEC fan calls himself an SEC fan and says, "Bah, Alabama, Auburn, who cares?" That's obviously not going to go with SEC fans.
No, that looks
so I understand there's a certain, you know, ownership of soccer when you are a soccer fan. Like
I
JJ.
I can't even fathom somebody saying, Alabama, Auburn. No, boy, who cares?
Of course. But I mean, there are moments like here. Give me an example. I don't want to get too far in this because I've got some things to talk about. But the deal is that we can get into the game yesterday because it's nationalism. It's our country. It's patriotism, and I told you the story before, and it's true. The first time I heard USA ever chanted at a national sporting event, and I made my life, by the way, going to national sporting events for 20-some years prior to that, was at Lake Placid, the Americans, when they played the Russians. That's the first time I ever heard USA chanted. That's
see, and you just mentioned Lake Placid, and I got a chill throughout my whole body. Because that's what it does.
It's cold up there.
But that's the memory of that. And I'm not a hockey guy.
But
send a chill through me because it was USA.
You didn't need to be a hockey guy, and that's my point.
Right.
So it transcends, patriotism transcends the sport. I remember trying to tell my late brother-in-law, Armin Lovell, why this game was so important when the Americans won a Russia, because it wasn't on national TV. It was
tape delayed.
Yeah, and I said, look, it's a hockey game, but it's really a big game, and he wasn't getting it. So my point is it's like to people who weren't hockey fans trying to explain that, would be if you're like trying to explain yesterday's win over Ghana to a non-soccer fan who says, who cares?
But
well, it was the third time Ghana's put us out of the World Cup. The last two times in a row.
But see, you follow a little bit. JJ just drilled some soccer.
He did. JJ did.
So you kind of
like I know that the guy that did set up the corner kick at the for the second goal.
Yeah,
he's from Orlando.
See, you knew that. So there you go. So you're starting. So here, and this is my point exactly. A little bit of osmosis has to take place here. You know what osmosis is, Tom. I'm not sure if Christian does, but he probably is a smart guy. Osmosis, the process of, you know, of sort of a sponge.
Just wears off on
being a sponge, and you just sort of pick it up. Like Miss Joni says, I know a lot of facts uses I've learned by osmosis. She heard these sports facts. Anyway, real quick to get to the point is that now what happens when you've got Brazil and Mexico today playing, it's halftime. And it's a scoreless game.
Snoozeville.
Well, it's supposed to be, you know, a big deal. Obviously, the Brazil is the home team, and Mexico has outplayed them the first half. Now, that would make a big story if, in fact, Mexico knocks off Brazil. Because in Brazil, if you don't win, they shoot you and kill you. So there you go. So, yeah. And referees better make a bad call. But anyway, so we'll talk more about soccer. But again, I thought, well, I'm going to try to take a different approach. I thought, when I went in and saw my grandson Alexander watching the game with his dad, who's
Gary's big soccer guy,
France, yeah,
he's from France,
and he turned to me and said, "Poppy, that's football."
So
I'm thinking, okay, I get that's what it is in Europe, and I get that that's what his dad, you know, what calls it, although he doesn't calls football in his country, and I thought, what do I say? Do I say no, it's not? Do I say, it's football, but, you know, it's not our football? Or what do you say? So I said, right or wrong, well, in Europe, they call it football. And over here, we call it soccer. Now, so there's where the cultural difference comes in, is that if I said to you, that's football, what would you say?
That I played it for a long time.
Yeah.
Had quarterback, centers, linemen,
and you had pads.
Linebackers.
Yeah. But you get my point. So you start to get these marginal things that come up that you think, okay.
Soccer's a game with the white and black patch ball.
Okay. You get my point. It's the cultural difference that makes the sport, you know, it's not quite, we don't have the gravity.
And the
yet,
American
you know?
Gravitas says that we're right about the names of it. When the rest of the world says, it's football and American football.
Well,
two separate things.
Here's what I figured out the problem was with soccer's lasting. I'll tell you the issue, one of the soccer things, the issue. But let's go ahead and take a break. Heard about this prostitution sting that went
21
on?
21 people.
Yeah, we're talking about that next.
Wow.
And I don't think it's a place you want to see your name.
No,
I'm just
no.
saying, you know, a lot of places.
But one guy who was an elderly gentleman said, you know, I'm old. I just wanted to party.
Yeah, right. Well, you better find another way to party. And then Marilyn Monroe, still one of the most beautiful women of all time.
Yes.
In my lifetime, of all the women who come through, there have been some beautiful women. J-Lo's a beautiful woman. But Marilyn Monroe was such an iconic figure that she has such a distinct look that she and Elizabeth Taylor in her day, they were probably as beautiful a woman as you'd ever want to see.
If you asked me my top 10 most beautiful women ever,
I didn't ask
Marilyn Monroe would make the list.
Yeah,
she was dead long before I was born.
And she would be
be way up the list.
So I know a little bit about Marilyn Monroe because I grew up with her, obviously. But there's some things I don't know, and I read five of them today. I'm going to share that with you, all right? Plus, Dr. Oz. He's the Mac Daddy of healthy food, healthy living, all this stuff.
He may be a little angry.
He got a little trouble. He got a Dr. Oz who's everybody. I used to hear Dr. Oz says this, Dr. Oz says that, Dr. Oz says that. Yeah, okay, fine. Right. He's all everywhere on television. I'm thinking now all of a sudden maybe Dr. Oz said a little too much, and his integrity. That's I'm calling it like it is, being somewhat called into question here, and he got roasted today up in Washington. So I'll tell you about that. And yeah, guess what? This is big news. More recalls for GM.
Yeah.
What else is happening
yeah,
today?
Yeah, exactly. Hey, and you know, I found this because it's all, you know, remember we did the 11 places in Florida that you got to visit?
Small towns. Quaint small towns.
I love the state of Georgia.
Yeah?
I found 7 places in the state of Georgia that you absolutely have to go to, and they're very, very nice places to view in the state of Georgia. Even a Floridian like you would enjoy them, buddy.
All right. I'll be looking forward to that. We'll take a break. Come back for more right here on The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're streaming live because we're live and local on The Source. Regions Bank has big bank ability but possesses small bank agility. Utilizing tools like Raymond Andrews and his team of six mortgage experts with 100 years of experience in the mortgage industry and 50 years experience as members of the Regions Bank team. Mortgage lending is personal and important, and you deserve someone that will lead you through a positive process. Raymond and his team use local mortgaging processes like local appraisers and local closing to help you have a positive experience, and they habla Espanol as well. So whether you need a conventional, FHA, USDA, or VA loan, or you even need a construction loan, the mortgage team of your local Regions Bank has the knowledge and experience to guide you through the process. So contact Raymond Andrews and his team of mortgage experts at 352-854-4104. That's 352-854-4104. Regions Bank, it's time to expect more.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
You know what that anticipation feels like when you're about to open a gift? In a Box offers personalized gifts, everything you'll need for that special occasion. In a Box. Holidays, birthdays, graduations, spa days, weddings, anniversaries, get wells, and more. In a Box. Visit InABoxCelebrations.com and pick your theme. There's even a corporate option. In a Box creates the magic, and you'll be the rock star. Visit InABoxCelebrations.com, partnered with Woodley Gardens.
Who would you feed if you had 50 chicken sandwiches from Chick-fil-A? WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall have teamed up to reward one organization with 50 chicken sandwiches as a way of saying thanks for the great work that organization is doing in our community. And we need your help. See, there are so many great people doing great things that we need nominations. You can nominate your own organization or any organization you choose. Simply send an email to WOCA@WOCA.com. And in 350 words or less, tell us why the organization you are nominating should receive 50 free chicken sandwiches from WOCA and Chick-fil-A at the Paddock Mall. We'll review your nominations and then select one deserving organization each month. We'll announce the winner and even read the winning entry on the air. Make sure to include the contact name and phone number of the organization that you are nominating. And thanks from your friends at WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall.
Got a garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey everybody, this is Kelly Hart, your new host of the Ocala Magazine Radio Show. Join me every Friday at 10 a.m. when we bring the pages of Ocala Magazine to life with in-depth interviews from and about your community. So don't miss Marion County's favorite city magazine, Ocala Magazine, every Friday at 10 a.m. right here on 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Your official news source, WOCA.
Clock. We got Buddy Sports Page. Scott, go long today. Tom Schmidt will talk about what player defines the modern era of the NBA. Tom James wants to talk about, is football the only non-niche sport now. And mine is about the misfortune of being Will, as in Muschamp. Coming up to you at 5:30 today. Dave Pingler will be on the program as well. Get his thoughts. You know, here's the thing about soccer. I'm endeavoring to really kind of get re-energized. And the Americans, by the way, you guys all laughed at the Americans, said they had no shot of winning anything. But, you know.
No, I just don't think they can get out of their pool.
Well, but I didn't expect Portugal to get crushed. Or they call that the murder bracket or something?
Yeah, whatever that is.
Right. See, I'm trying to learn that. Anyway, so I'm trying.
Bracket of death or something.
Bracket of death, yeah, that's what it is. So the deal is that, and I'm watching the soccer. Don't love it. I liked yesterday's game a lot. How could you not like it? I watched the first half, and then I never saw so many Americans going down. My gosh, they just like it looked like the old Packers and Green Bay and the old Packers Bears games. You know, when Buck was just playing.
Jose Altidore is a big. That's a big loss. If he can't come back from bad strain.
The other cat got the broken nose, and what's his name? Not Bradley, the other one. I can't remember his name. Sorry, I'm relearning. I remember the players that played last time, most of them, but this guy did. So I'm saying to you, I'm thinking, well, here's one of the props. Now, I don't know if Christian, do you follow soccer at all? You play basketball. Now you go at Trinity, but you don't play soccer, do you?
I played soccer for 2 years.
Okay, do you like soccer?
Yes, sir.
Okay, do you follow the World Cup at all?
Yes.
All right, you watch the United States yesterday at all?
Yeah, yes.
Okay, all right. Get pretty pumped about it?
Yes, I didn't think the United States was going to win that one, actually.
Yeah, great goal at the end there. That's terrific.
Who knew Dempsey makes a great move 32 seconds into the game?
Yes.
That was a gift right there. They looked it up. They talked about the ESPN radio. Was that the fastest ever? And it wasn't, but it was right up there. And, you know, and the thing about it is you wonder why they go crazy. When you only score one goal in the game, that's the only chance you get. I mean, so here's my deal. I think one of the things maybe soccer is lacking is a sense of humor.
Definitely.
Think about it.
I've never thought of that.
It needs a sense of humor, you know, and everything is like, oh, my God, kill me. Oh, I'm dead. I'm dying. Oh, you know. And if you say something about the game and the person's a soccer fan, they hate you, and they shoot people for losing games, I'm thinking maybe we lighten it up a little bit, right, on soccer, and we all have a little more fun. So I thought, well, let's Google soccer jokes, right?
Well,
I did.
Right.
I just did. All right. So here's what I got, okay? Here are a couple samples from this particular article. What do you get if you see a Germany fan buried up to his neck in sand? Answer, more sand. What's the difference between England and an albatross? I don't get this at all. An albatross has got two decent wings. I mean, I guess
the English team doesn't have a good wings.
I get that, but is it funny?
It is if you're a soccer fan.
That's what I'm saying to you. They need a sense of humor, okay? What's the difference between the Portugal team and the Bermuda Triangle? The Bermuda Triangle has 3 points.
Portugal doesn't. They got none against Germany.
I don't hear a lot of laughter, though. I mean, I'm not hearing a lot.
Needs to branch out.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. Let's see. Why did Cinderella get kicked off the football team? As in soccer? Because she kept running away from the ball. So I'm saying, need some jokes, need some humor. This is not it, okay? Wait.
Say that joke again, maybe I'll get it.
No, you're going to set me up for something.
No.
I'm not falling into your trap. No. How about What does a Lionel Messi? What does Lionel Messi and a magician have in common? What does a Lionel Messi and a magician have in common? Both do hat tricks. Yeah, they laughed, but it's just not funny. It's just not funny. Now, I don't know if this sounds like an English sense of humor. I'm not sure British sense of humor, but so I didn't find it there. If you've got a good soccer joke, email it to us. We could use it. Because I haven't seen anything so far. So we'll keep you up to date. Now, Christian, keep checking on that Mexico-Brazil game, and we'll do our best to stay on top of nothing at halftime, and now they should be about ready to start playing again. Of course, if you don't understand how they put time back on the clock at the end of the game, as they did yesterday in the game between the United States and Ghana, you go nuts. My wife says, what are they doing? They're making the game longer. Yeah, they do that.
The problem with soccer comedy is timing, buddy.
Is that what it is?
See, look, now the rim shot.
Oh, I like that rim shot. Where'd you find it? I've been looking for it for 3 years.
Soccer did it.
Why did we finally get a rim shot for soccer, but I can't get it anyplace
else?
Well,
because timing, but the timing of it was terrible.
Now, let me hear, do you have a soccer joke?
I don't.
Oh. Oh, you dig what
I... That's how bad the soccer joke was. You just got the rim shot just then. Soccer joke's been over
late.
For a minute and a half.
Way late. Used to be on Saturday Night Live, a guy who had rim shots all the wrong place. Remember him?
Yeah.
Every time.
Yeah,
right exactly, now. Yeah. Either later, right? Or right, the joke
yeah.
was over.
Yeah.
All right, so we will... later on, you'll find a soccer joke and you'll play a rim shot. Let's get on with the program today. Let's talk about Marilyn Monroe. You know, the most famous picture, there's one of her skirt blowing up, you know.
Right.
We all know that. That's, Marilyn Monroe, an iconic movie star, who looks like a movie star, she received only $50 to pose for the nude photos that appeared in Playboy. $50. Photographer Tim Kelly originally took a pictures in 49 for Ocala 1949, but Hugh Hefner bought the negatives from the Ocala company. Years later, after Monroe was on the rise, he paid $500. Big deal. The photos made millions for Hugh Hefner. Number two, what size dress would you think that Marilyn Monroe wore?
Now, she's like a 14, 16.
See, my wife asked this. I asked this question to my wife. Not so fast, my friend. A fashion editor for the Times of London dispelled the rumor that she wore 16 by trying on the articles of clothing. Sarah Bies is the name. While she was undeniably voluptuous, in possession of ample bosom, she says, and a bottom that would look good gyrating in a J-Lo video, I'm just describing what she said. For the most part, early part of her career, she was a size 8. And even in her plumper stages, no more than a 10.
Wow, I thought she was always like a 14,
she
16.
Came off as big in a way that was not offensive on the screen. But yeah, most people thought she was 16. She was hyper aware of her persona. And a lot of people talked about it, why she was so different when she wasn't, quote unquote, in character. Truman Capote once found her gazing into a mirror and asked what she was doing, and she replied, looking at her. Talking about herself in the third person. Hmm. Number four, Monroe stuttered through a childhood and teens. She was a bad stutterer.
I didn't know that.
I did not know that. I don't know how it happened. Sometimes I was very nervous or excited. I would stutter, she said. A speech therapist gave her help to get over the impediment by instructing her to use breathier tones. She would talk like this. And finally... Need a great side dish to go with your next holiday meal? 2008 collection of Monroe's writings, letters, and poems, including her personal recipe for stuffing, which is found scribbled on a piece of stationery from the City Title Insurance Company. The New York Times reprinted and recreated the unorthodox recipe. Had liver, heart, beef, eggs, and raisins, among other things, and gave her high marks for flavor, texture, and presentation.
That's just Southern wet dressing.
Who knew Marilyn Monroe knew how to make good dressing?
That's just Southern wet dressing. My mom used to put oysters and livers and hearts and all in her dressing.
No, I don't want any of that stuff in my dressing.
That's good stuff.
No, I don't want any of that stuff in my
dressing. We had the stuffing that went in the turkey, and then you had that kind of dressing, too. It was good stuff.
Yeah. So, anyway, that's Marilyn Monroe. Dr. Oz, so we'll move on to this along a little bit. Dr. Oz, you ever buy a Dr. Oz product?
No.
I didn't either, but a lot of people have. My wife buys them, and I noticed the woman on CNN said she bought some. It has his pictures on them, whatever. And for a long time, my wife would say, Dr. Oz says, Dr. Oz says, Dr. Ed says. So today, he's up in, I wouldn't say testifying for a hearing. He's up visiting with a committee up in Washington who are talking about false advertising on supplements. And one of the things she put out is green coffee bean extract, a substance derived from coffee, marketed as a weight loss supplement.
Now, yeah, but he didn't market it.
Well, he did market some of it too. He did, but he's put out weight loss products.
I watched the thing on today.
But I mean,
this
he's
morning.
Had weight loss products.
Right.
Yeah.
He's suing this company actually.
Yeah. So Oz's likeness has appeared on countless advertisements for products, including that ingredient.
Right. But he's suing the company for doing that.
But he put his name and face on it.
No, he didn't. They did against his things. I watched the Today Show this morning. He was on the Today Show this morning before he testified in front of Washington, And he said he is not any part of that group. He's suing them for using his likeness, that he never once endorsed that product or told them to put his likeness on.
You're right. And the point is that they called him up to Washington because of that.
Right.
And the bottom line was that they grilled him. They grilled him on it and said he has a big bully pulpit there on television, and he puts things out, and he needs to be real more careful, and he agreed with it. He said, the Federal Trade Commission has brought a suit against this extract company for a bogus weight loss thing. But the deal is that he's at Capitol Hill testifying in a Senate hearing about weight loss scams and talking about false advertising. He was adamant that he is not involved, as you said, in any sale of any nutritional supplements, that he's stopped using overblown words like miracle on his program. That he's guilty on.
Yes, he is. He does that all the time. He says he's trying not to anymore.
Yeah, he says. But anyway, he was the guy that everybody thought was clean as a whistle. He was the guy. So his integrity is just a little bit.
It's taking a little hit
here. So
it has.
Didn't expect to see him. Okay, coming up next, we'll talk a little more about. I'm a little nervous about what's happening over in Baghdad. You know, I know it's.
I'm getting a little concerned.
Oh, we're just going to go send a few troops. Yeah, I've heard that before. Let's talk about that coming up next.
No, I'm getting concerned that we need to do more.
Yeah, let's see. You that's all we need. Another war in Iraq. Coming back another Saturday, we'll talk about it right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, live and local on The Source. Like that's what you want to do.
It's the ultimate summer staycation, just minutes from downtown Ocala, but miles away from the ordinary. A summer sports or summer golf membership at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club is your all-inclusive ticket to a summer filled with activities and fun from June through September. A summer membership at Golden Ocala opens the door to a world-class setting. Is golf your game? Is tennis your passion? Or is lounging poolside more your speed? Want to get in shape? Work out in the state-of-the-art fitness center and then relax and unwind in the sauna or the spa. Summer members also have use of the Equestrian Center at Golden Ocala, offering full board and paddock, impeccable trails, and a jumping ring for riders of all ages. Summer memberships are going fast, so visit goldenocala.com and explore the options. Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. This summer, you can live there and still play here.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of the Properties Salon in downtown Ocala. Here in Florida, we're all about summertime fun, but along with the warm weather comes humidity, which leads to the dreaded frizzies. Are you tired of checking the weather report every morning before deciding to flat iron your hair? Sick of looking like the Lion King every day by noon? Has God just not seen fit to answer your prayers for patience and silky, frizz-free hair? Well, your troubles are over. Come to the Properties Salon for one of our hair smoothing systems, specializing in Peter Coppola and Cezanne keratin smoothing treatments. The Properties Salon can tame your unruly locks with these formaldehyde-free formulas. And with the discount code BUDDYROCKS, you will save 20%. Not fighting the frizzies? Mention the same code BUDDYROCKS to save 20% off one of our many services such as cuts, color extensions, and manis and pedis. Gentlemen, this special is not just for the ladies. We do great cuts and color for men too. Check us out at theproperties.com for more information.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler.
Regardless of how long it takes, we will find you.
The president on Sunday's capture near Benghazi of a key suspect in the consulate attack that killed four Americans. The suspect now on a Navy ship in international waters.
A intelligence interrogation team has been working with the suspect, Ahmed Abu Qatala. When they feel there's no more intelligence that they can get, they will then Mirandize him and pass him off to an FBI team that will then interrogate him for a potential trial in the U.S. And he, we've now learned, will be brought back to a U.S. District Court in Washington, D.C.
Fox's Jennifer Griffin. The National Weather Service says four powerful tornadoes hit Pilgrim, Nebraska yesterday. Two people killed. Charges dropped against singer Paul Simon and wife Edie Brickell, the couple arrested in April after an altercation at their home. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At Termbusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call Termbusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting. Exam required to qualify.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Bond, Mike Bond. He's an award-winning poet and a human rights correspondent, and he's with the BBC, coming on to speak to us about his book, House of Jaguar. It's a thriller novel based on Mike Bond's own experiences in Guatemala.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Brad Nimmo will be in the studio. He's the president and CEO of Habitat for Humanity of Marion County. He's coming in with Sarah Isaacs. They'll be talking to us about the Mud Volleyball Tournament Bump, Set, and Build fundraising event.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Harlem Globetrotter Buckets Blakes is coming on the air with us, celebrating the 89th consecutive year of the Harlem Globetrotters.
Jay Scott is the co-executive director of Alex's Lemonade Stand Foundation. He'll be speaking about the foundation dedicated to finding a cure for childhood cancer.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require a $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
Working my way back to you, babe, with a burning love inside. Hey, I'm working my way back to you, babe, and the happy.
Talking about my era now, the music.
You know, that movie starts June 20th.
That's when I can't wait to see.
At the Jersey Boys at the Marion Theater. Yeah,
I didn't see the play on Broadway. We went to New York, and there were tickets for like $250 a piece.
And so you didn't go?
No. No, we're not going to the Super
Bowl. Well, you know, three of the four guys that are in the movie, that Clint Eastwood hired directly. They were the three of the four four tops on Broadway.
Yeah.
The only one that's not is the guy that's in Boardwalk Empire.
Well, the Four Tops is different than Frankie Valli.
I meant the Four Seasons, excuse me.
Yeah.
Four Seasons.
Four Tops for the dancers.
Right.
They were good.
The Four Seasons, three of the guys that are in the movie were also the Broadway guys.
Yeah. I think Christian got in the spirit of things, if you get your rim shot ready. He found a soccer joke. We'll see if we continue on. We're trying hard. Chris is digging deep for this, Tom. So let's give Christian a chance. This is his comic debut here on the radio, all right? Here's Christian Cobos with a soccer joke. Take it away, Christian.
All right, the question is, why do soccer players do so well in math?
Why do soccer players do so well in math, Tom?
I don't know why.
They know how to use their heads. Ha, 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 ha,
I'll say maybe it works better when you got the rim shot like that.
That's still not it.
No? I thought he delivered it
pretty well. Although the American did good last night using his head. That's pretty good.
Yes, he did. I thought he delivered it pretty well for his first
show. It was a great delivery.
He wants to do another one.
Uh-oh, he's got
now one more. He's got the hang of this thing now. Get your rim shot ready. All right, Christian, go for it.
I was actually going to say airline Delta on Twitter got shootout because they posted a tweet about as the U.S., they had the Statue of Liberty, and as the Ghana team, they had a giraffe. 2-1. And they a giraffe as the their picture.
Oh, okay.
So the Statue of Liberty versus giraffe. Well,
giraffe.
The giraffe is its natural habitat is in Ghana.
And it's also almost as tall as the Statue of Liberty. Not really, but we'd say that. Boom, there you go. Thank you very much. All right, enough jokes. Hey, listen, this is not a funny thing here, but this prostitution sting they set up. Now, we'll have something to talk about with the sheriff and the chief on Friday. I asked the cops to do the show. Agents, so they have this unified drug enforcement strike team. We heard them talk about this over at, on the Ask the Cops show with Sheriff Blair and Chief Graham. They set up this sting, arrested 21 men and women on prostitution charges and seized drugs, cash, their car. And this was to identify and arrest people engaged in prostitution or solicit prostitution using an online posting. I've never heard of this. Backpage.com.
So I hadn't either, which is good that we've never, neither one of us ever heard of.
I went on it to see what it was. It's just a bunch of listings.
So like Craigslist,
yes,
but different?
Yes, like okay. Craigslist. And it has, obviously has categories. I didn't go into it in depth. I didn't want to see what it was about. Anyway, so apparently advertised.
In case they had, Buddy Martin's name ever comes up in one of these sting operations.
That will never happen, by the way. A lot of things that could happen. That's not one.
He was just doing research for a story.
Yeah. They answer the ad on a predetermined location and they got busted. So there are sexual favors from $35 to $260. And it came from Ocala, but also one truck driver came from Chicago.
Came all the way from Chicago.
Bad, he probably was passing through. Bad decision. One woman was from Puerto Rico. Said she'd been in Florida for a couple of months, according to Ocala.com. And other people gave agents some reasons like the one you talked about. One man told agents he wanted, quote, to party.
Since old
I'm
man.
An old man. Married, by the way, 20 years. Oh, he was married 20 years.
Right.
We'll find out.
Yeah, he won't be now.
And there's 21. They're listed. All the names are listed, and as they should be, by the way.
What got me, buddy, was they confiscated crack cocaine, powdered cocaine, prescription mm-hmm. drugs,
yeah.
marijuana, $1,400 in cash, a Mercury Grand Marquis. I mean, these people look like they want to do more than just have sex in this hotel room. Goodness.
Well, we talked to the mayor and to the chief about this whole thing on this whole operation, and they sort of been working on this thing for quite some time. So anyway, good job by the cops out there cleaning up our streets. I noticed I don't see nearly the number of streetwalkers on Highway 40 or Blue Boulevard as I used to see several years ago. So
no.
That's good. Okay, let's talk about a serious subject here. I wrote myself a note. Under the heading U.S. sending troops to Iraq, I wrote myself down saying, "What are we doing here?" I have seen this movie. Now you can talk about the reasons for doing it, and you can justify it anyway. 300 armed American forces positioned in and around Iraq. We got the Navy's got some ships in the Persian Gulf. Barack Obama is going to arm himself against the Islamic insurgents. Maybe use airstrikes. And I understand that we have to do certain things, but no matter what you say, we seem to always be able to justify getting into wars on foreign land. We always have some reason to do that. And I'm afraid, what's this phrase? In for a little bit, in for a lot.
Right.
And I'm worried about
in for a penny,
that.
In for a pound.
In for a penny, for a pound. And that's scary. That's scary. Good news is special forces in Libya caught a suspect in the Benghazi attack. He was actually out and clear. I mean, he was living in a place that was open, and actually CNN had interviewed him. Other media have. He was right there, but somehow they were able to capture this suspect Benghazi, take him out of the country in a secret commando operation. His name is Ahmed Abu Kataya, captured Sunday. So, the people in Washington asked why did it take so long. They said, well, they had to get the evidence together. But they do have a suspect, which I guess is a good thing. I'm sure Hillary Clinton might be breathing a sigh of relief in that one, too, as a matter of fact, too. Disturbing news. An elephant is killed by poachers every 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And that means if you do the math, there will be no elephants in 12 years. I read a short note on the internet about this iconic elephant that was well known was one of the ones that was just killed. And it's just, you know, I know they stopped allowing them to sell the ivory, but the poachers keep coming. They keep coming. Every 15 minutes, an elephant is killed.
Did you see that there was a picture on Facebook of how they cut the tusk out and everything? They just cut the whole front face of the elephant off.
Brutal. Awful. A little bit of good news. There's the first condor has been spotted in California in San Mateo County in nearly 110 years.
There's a California condor has been spotted.
Yes.
Wow. I thought they were extinct.
Yeah. Well, they're not. 110 years. So you asked the question earlier, Tom, by the way, as I'm bouncing around here. Where were you 20 years ago? I've said this on the show a lot of times, so I won't go into great detail. And you asked the question during the first hour, and we can continue that on in the sports
where
hour
were
as
you
well.
The OJ.
I was in Pittsburgh, and I was sitting with Dan Jenkins in the NBA at the U.S. Open media room, about to watch the NBA playoffs, which are going on at that time.
Yeah, that was the last competitive round of golf Arnold Palmer played at U.S. Open.
Oakmont, his home course there.
Right.
And we were sitting there, they stopped the telecast, and all of a sudden there was this bulletin in this white car, and this is how it all started. I read the article yesterday. It's kind of confusing about what happened to his Ford Bronco. It's been up and down and back and around and sold and resold, whatever. And the article is a long article in USA Today. In the end, they don't really know where it is, but apparently Al Cowlings owned the car, and he did sell it for $75,000, and somebody else got it. I believe it was a porn king. And I believe he sold it for $200,000. And wherever it is now, they're kind of making a secret out of it. But the famous white Bronco. Here's the thing I want to say about O.J. We can talk about this more later. We tend to forget, although he's looked upon as a scumbag now, what an incredible sports hero O.J. Simpson was. Think about this. The number one brand in sports then was Arnold Palmer, just prior to that. He did all these commercials. I mean, he was a money machine when it came to commercials. His credibility was awesome. He used to run through airports with Arnold Palmer.
Yeah.
And he didn't, Arnold wasn't running,
him
but he
and
was.
Palmer did the Hertz commercials
he was
together.
A very popular guy. I went to Buffalo once when I worked with CBS. Terry Bradshaw and I went to Buffalo, went over to the complex. OJ was there working for NBC. He was waiting around for some players as we were. We sat with OJ for 2 hours, just hung out. He was a nice guy. I mean, at least that was what it appeared to be. And as a guy who was very well respected, people really idolized this guy. This is not like this guy was some, you know, drug dealer or whatever. He was a really iconic figure in sports. And Dan Jenkins could not accept the fact that OJ might have killed Nicole Brown Simpson, although now there's a book out saying it was OJ's son, but that remains to be seen. But I just got to put it in perspective. I mean, Christian Cobos wasn't even born then.
No, it was 5 years before
he was born. I'm sure he's heard about it, but OJ Simpson was a superstar, megastar at USC, Buffalo Bills, Heisman Trophy winner, great player, 2,000 yards gainer in the NFL. And it's such a shock, the story is such a shock to people's systems. And then this whole Bronco thing was sort of the height of absurdity in him and Al Cowlings driving on the freeways with all these police cars behind them. What they worried about was there was an implication that OJ had a gun in the car and might kill himself. Remember?
Yes.
That was the deal. Anyway, that's what 20 years ago, this is what was going on. Crazy stuff. Tom.
Yes.
You ever have any regrets about things you didn't do or do?
Yes, one.
Yeah.
I've had
the last 15 minutes?
No, one, literally. They're saying, I won't get into it, but there's one thing that I regret that I didn't do because I don't know how it would have turned out, and I still, to this day, think about it probably once or twice a month.
Well, that's a big decision. There's a lot of small decisions that you might wish you did as well. I'm going to give you a couple real quick, then I'm going to take a break and play Faker and Factoid. I've got a list of things that you won't regret when you're older if you do them now. Turn off your phone when you're at dinner. Say goodbye to a toxic friend. Wake up early and get stuff done. I was up at 5 o'clock today writing, by the way. Saying no to plans when you're totally overwhelmed, and on and on. There's a whole bunch of these, like 27 of them. It goes on and on and on. Here's one that's interesting. Not going to your high school reunion.
Huh.
Unless you had the very best time in the school, don't bother. You'll keep in touch with the people who matter. Telling your family how much they mean to you as often as possible. I agree with that one. Taking photos of the family gatherings and holidays. Keeping a photo album filled with your favorite moments. Those are things as a person gets older, you do, in fact, are glad you did. Here's one. I don't want to read it because you might get any ideas. Ask for a raise. Take advantage of all your vacation days. Yeah, we got a lot of those. Trying to make your corner of the world a better place to live. Spending more money than you expected on a trip. You'll remember the rest of your life. That right. I've done now.
Hey, buddy, this just out. I was going to give you the 7th place in Georgia. We'll do that later this week. Oh. But this just out from BuzzFeed. 11 awesome summer day trips for major U.S. cities. Mm-hmm. You got Brooklyn to Montauk, Portland to Astoria. Number 7 on the list.
Mm-hmm.
From Orlando to Ocala, Florida.
How about that?
How about that?
Yeah. What's that list on BuzzFeed?
It's on BuzzFeed. It's the 11 awesome summer day trips from major U.S. cities.
Well, you know,
number 7 on the list, from Orlando to Ocala.
You know, Dr. O'Malley talked about his drive from Orlando up here, what it was like, and what a beautiful place. Great. That's a good thing to know. Yeah. That's 2 good things in national media. We had the Marion Theater.
We had the Marion Theater.
On the Wall Street Journal.
Yeah, there you go.
Let's take a break, and we'll see if Kristen can beat you again in Faker Factor. Or stay tuned to the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're streaming live at WOCA.com.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440, or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
Into your America's favorite game, Faker Factor. Today's tweet your quotes. The main thing is to keep the main thing the main thing. Stephen Covey. Number 2, I love this, and this is from Erica. An officer pulled me over and asked if I knew what the speed limit was. Like I'm getting paid to tell him how to do his job. Number 3, from Winston Churchill. You have enemies? Good. That means you stood up for something sometime in your life. All right, here we go. Christian Komas versus Tom Schmitz. We'll see who's going to be the winner today on America's Favorite Game. Number 1, the state with the highest percentage of people who walk to work is Alaska.
Fake.
Fact.
Score 1 for Christian. That's a fact. Number 2, the state with the highest percentage of people who commute by motorcycle or bicycle, Wisconsin.
Fact.
Yeah, fact.
Anybody want to change their answer?
No.
It's fake. Tom has 2 misses. Number 3, India has over 50 million monkeys.
Fact.
Fake.
Tom says fake. Christian says fact. Tom is out after three. Wow, Christian annihilated you.
Yeah, well, we had
all right. Let me go ahead and just get a couple more in here. Next year, Australia. Libya has the most koala bears.
Fake.
Fake.
It's fake. Number five, elephants are the only animals that can't jump.
Fact.
Yeah, fact.
That's a fact. Although they kind of do a little something in the circuses, they don't really jump. And finally, the number of pounds of garbage, it's by the way in the billions, that's dumped into our oceans every year.
6 billion.
Six billion.
4 billion.
4 billion. Tom's closer. It's 14 billion.
Wow.
14 billion pounds of garbage dumped in our oceans every year. That is staggering. Unbelievable. There you go. That was a quick and easy game there.
Yeah.
It didn't last very long. Tom, go back to that article. Turn off that 24 music. Go back to the article you read about the trips. That's really interesting. We just find this on the internet about day trips. And you mentioned one was Denver to Golden. I've been there, done that one. I have not been Brooklyn to Montauk, by the way. But
trying to find the favorites here.
Yeah, and just do your history, and you'll find it. And then, that's pretty cool that they would have a little something there from Orlando to Ocala. So maybe little by little, the voice of Ocala is getting the word out there to people. You know?
Yeah, awesome summer trips from the awesome summer, 11 awesome summer day trips from major U.S. cities. One is Brooklyn. Number one, they say the best day trip is from Brooklyn to Montauk, New York.
I'm not taking that one. I wouldn't mind that. I know Montauk's a beautiful place.
Portland to Astoria, Oregon.
I don't think I've been there.
Santa Cruz to Big Sur, California.
Okay, that's got to be pretty.
Boston to Nantucket.
That's a beautiful trip.
Right. I've done this numerous times, this trip here. Number five, Vegas to the Grand Canyon. It is amazing. I've done the helicopter tour twice.
Have you?
From Los Angeles to Intergraton in Landers, California. I don't know what that is.
I haven't heard of it.
From Orlando to Ocala.
How about that? Top 10, Orlando.
It says there are tons of lakes.
Let's read the whole thing.
Of lakes, trails, and springs, salt and freshwater, to visit in Ocala and the Ocala National Forest and the Alexander Springs area. It is always 72 degrees and clear. Pack a picnic lunch and see what outdoor learning activities are being offered the day you're there.
That needs to be posted on Facebook, and that's exactly what we need to get out to the rest of the world. Ecotourism is very much alive.
Number eight, I don't know, this is a major U.S. city, Augusta, Georgia.
Really?
But they said from Augusta to Hilton Head. I would think Hilton Head's a bigger city than Augusta, but they're close.
Kind of a meandering drive.
It is. It would be a terrible drive.
It's a difficult drive.
Okay? Takes less than 3 hours to cross state lines.
Yeah.
Savannah to Hilton Head would be great.
Not a good drive.
Savannah to Hilton Head.
Right.
25 minutes.
Not to Augusta.
Right. From L.A. to Salvation Mountain in Nyland.
Never been there.
From El Paso to Marfa, Texas.
Well, that's got
to
be a long
and then
drive there.
From Denver to Golden, Colorado.
Beautiful little town, Golden.
Yeah, so there they are, the 11 most. But number seven on the list, Orlando to Ocala.
All right, final score. Just handed this by Kristen Comas. Brazil, 0. Mexico, 0.
What was that score again?
0-0. Mexico and Brazil. There you go.
Oh, that wasn't a Joe. I'm sorry.
I rest my case about soccer being boring sometimes. There you go. Coming up next, Buddy Sports Page. Stay tuned to the voice of Ocala right here on
The Source. And you taught me how
to say. Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Here are the categories.
I'll take Mike Scott Plumbing for 1,000, please, Alex.
Answer. Daily double.
I'll wager 5,000.
All right. Here is the clue. PU is the type of this complication.
What is a sewage backup?
Yes, that's right.
It's all fun and games until something happens to you, like a septic system failure or a clogged drain or line, leaving you saying PU. But not to worry. Mike Scott Plumbing is there to get you out of that jeopardy and back on track. And they don't charge extra for nights, weekends, or holidays. From septic pumping to lawn irrigation to high-efficiency water heaters, at Mike Scott Plumbing, if water runs through it, we do it. Stop by one of the newly renovated showrooms in Hernando or Wildwood, or call today, 237-2888. That's 237-2888.
Mike Scott.
I'm Major George Patterson from the Salvation Army. Please stop by our family store at 120 Northwest 10th Street in Ocala, where on Wednesday you have a 50% off clothing and bric-a-brac. On Friday, 25% off furniture and large appliances. And on Saturday, stop by to our yard sale from 8:45 to 11. Donations can be made by calling 352-732-4469 and we'll pick it up. Funds from the store go toward the services that we provide in Marion County.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
When you kiss somebody for the first time, you subconsciously decipher a whole host of information about their health and your compatibility. Workers who scheduled a day off every few weeks saw their productivity increase to fresh off their vacation levels. Turns out, just seeing a strong-willed person stick to their goals, even in the face of temptation, increases your own motivation.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Habitat for Humanity of Marion County is a ministry dedicated to improving lives by providing affordable and decent housing. Help them help others by visiting the Habitat for Humanity Ocala ReStore at 926 Northwest 27th Avenue. To schedule a donation, give us a call at 401-0075 and we'll come pick it up. For more information, visit ocalarestore.org. Habitat for Humanity of Marion County. Building homes, building hope, building community.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler. A suspect in custody for the Benghazi consulate attack that killed four Americans. Ahmed Abu Katala, a local leader of the militant group Ansar al-Sharia.
Sunday, when he was grabbed south of Benghazi by the U.S. Special Operations Team, he was taken to a U.S. Navy vessel in international waters. That's where he was held in those initial hours and initial days. We understand that he is still on board that ship. The Pentagon will not tell us the name of the vessel, but it it is in international waters.
Fox's Jennifer Griffin, Nebraska's governor, calling this tornado damage the worst he's ever seen. Two giant side-by-side twisters slamming into the town of Pilger Monday, killing two.
The southeast corner of this town, about 20 homes are still standing, and that's really about it.
Fox's Mike Tobin, the Dow closing up 27, the NASDAQ gained 16. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At Termbusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call Termbusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting.
How much time? 30? 30 seconds? I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho! Ho, ho, ho!
And now it's time for the
Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
It's like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
here's Buddy.
Here I am. Go. All right. By the end of this week, you'll have this down.
No, I won't.
Well, it's been a while.
I just have to get some interns so I don't have to do this anymore.
Well, you did
it's
pretty
too
good.
Hard.
You did a pretty good job, but you got to get coached
up. Austin were way better at this.
But how do you teach them if you don't know, right?
That's a good point.
And it's all new equipment. This is totally different than what we started on. So it's not the same thing as we had. And by the way, much superior to the other station what we were going on.
Oh, yeah.
We used to have to dial with a pencil on the eraser.
You know, it's these kind of things that I need a day off, buddy.
No, you don't.
Like this Friday.
Yeah. Good. You got a weekend coming on July 4th.
$50,000 guaranteed, $350 buy-in.
Yeah.
But it starts at noon.
Yeah. Today on the program, we've got to go along a couple of segments. I think we'll hopefully entertain you, enlighten you, whatever, on the program. Tom James on his way in. He'll be talking about football being the only real sport that's non-niche. I think that's what he said.
Right. Yeah, football's the only non-niche sport. I don't know. I mean, basketball and baseball, I think, got an argument there. But I will find out.
Yeah. And yours is – I know what you're thinking, and I know what you want me to say, but I'm not going to say it. And I'm going to let you tell it. And that is – going back to the Bird and Magic era, who defined that era of basketball?
And then Jordan's era, who defines this era of basketball?
I know where you're going with this. We'll see. It's a good idea. I'm sure it'll be good. And then mine is, I got thinking about this. And this column just posted on southernpigskin.com is, I got thinking about Will Muschamp. He's been bashed a lot. I've done my share of criticizing him. And I got to thinking about him. Could you have worse luck than Will Muschamp has had the last 18 months?
How much of that luck did Will bring on himself?
Well, that's part of the column.
Very interested to hear this.
How many things can go wrong? I mean, we've seen a lot.
And well, so, started with Jeff Driscoll breaking his leg.
Yeah, I'm saying a lot of things have gone wrong. Yeah. And so if you're going to criticize him, I don't cut him a whole lot of slack on the injuries because they weren't any good before the injuries. And we talked about it on this program before that. I'm just saying, I'm trying to cut him a break here and say, okay, let's look at it and say, maybe we've been a little critical. Let's take a look. So the columns call The Misfortune of Being Will. And I'll be talking about that on my own.
Well, during football season, when there was another knee injury, that a lot of knee injuries happened up there, and that you had talked to somebody that said that was strength training.
Well, you think it is, but on the other hand, is that bad luck or is it just a bad program? I don't know. I'm not there enough to be able to make a judgment on that, and I'm not as close to the program as I used to be. I make no bones about that. But something's not right. I'm just trying to say, if you all put all the facts on the table and you look at it in a clinical fashion, if you did it with a sabermetrics, even, you know, whatever, which wouldn't be very favorable. The bottom line is, you know, how could one guy who should have been so perfect for this job, really, he had all the breeding for it, his background, he should have been, how could things be so bad with a guy that I think Jeremy Foley thought was his next Billy Donovan? Anyway, we'll stop it right there. Let's go to the headlines, talk about the soccer, the football world, things going on there, and then a little later on, we'll talk more about the Spurs, and we'll talk more about Urban Meyer's comments, talking about his 2018.
Well, the number one story today is the U.S. defeats Ghana, gets the proverbial monkey off their back, as it were. Ghana had put them out of the World Cup the last two times in a row, and in the pool of death, America gets 3 points by beating Ghana last night, 2-1. In a riveting, you know, just action-packed. Am I selling this good enough, buddy?
Get the rim shot ready. Game
of soccer.
Wild and woolly offensive explosion.
Yeah.
Another. This is hardly the fun and gun. I'll say that. I love that.
That's pretty good. I found it finally for you. You like that? So the U.S. gets off to a great start. Now they face Portugal, who will come out and face Portugal on Saturday or Sunday. It's one of those days, you know. And so, Portugal coming off
You don't even know when they're playing.
I don't care. 4-0 loss to Germany. Today, we already said there was a draw between Mexico and Brazil. Brazil, the host country, 0-0.
I call it a draw.
Nil draw.
To me, a draw is when you go to the post positions on the Kentucky Derby. That's a draw. To me, it's a tie, but that's okay. It's just me.
Now to a sport we all understand, the NFL. Neither tight end Vernon Davis nor offensive lineman Alex Boone showed up today for the mandatory minicamps. We talked about this yesterday where Vernon Davis said, it's about getting paid. I need to make my money.
Yeah.
Well, Jim Harbaugh was asked about it today. He said, I'm disappointed in the decision for them not to be here. It's not the decision I envisioned being the 49er way. Mm-hmm. Ooh, that's pretty strong stuff. That's not the 49er way. Mm-hmm. Davis, of course, said in a radio interview last weekend that he planned on attending the minicamp, then changed his tune earlier this week, indicating in a guest column for Sports Illustrated that he would hold out because I need to get my money. Now, with both officially holding out, the 49ers can start fining both Davis and Alex Boone.
Why, you don't think Davis is a team player?
Doesn't look like it.
Not so much, huh?
Doesn't look like it. So we'll see how that goes. In other NFLs today, Johnny Football has agreed to terms on a contract with the Cleveland Browns. Manziel, the 22nd pick overall in the draft. Of course, he's going to compete with Brian Hoyer for quarterback. Terms were not released, but the NFL rookie wage scale projects Manziel's deal to be worth about $8.25 million for 4 years.
Didn't take him any time to sign that contract.
Like all first-round picks, his contract also includes a fifth-year team option. Let's be honest. Let's call these what they are. They're one-year opt-outs for teams. because there is no, you can get cut from the NFL next year.
It's a whole lot better for the owners than it used to be.
It is. And finally, Tiger Woods, as the U.S. Open, had a 48% decline in viewership, buddy, over the weekend from last year's tournament. 48% decline in viewership.
About 90% of that was on Sunday.
Wow, 48%. Tiger Woods has advanced, according to his agent. Tiger Woods has advanced from chipping and putting as he continued to make progress in his comeback from back surgery. According to his agent, Tiger is making continual progress, Mark Steinberg said. He feels better each day and is extending his swing as he progresses. According to a report first on Golf Channel and then on Golf Digest, Woods wasn't watching the U.S. Open. Instead, he was hitting full shots, including his driver, at the Medalist Golf Club near his home in Jupiter. So, Tiger Woods now taking full swings with the golf club, not just putting and chipping. And believe me, I didn't want to admit this with Nui Scruggs earlier, saying that Tiger may have become bigger than the game of golf that we now have. Not bigger than the game overall, but bigger than the game that's there now. After a 48% drop-off, there may be something to that.
Let me just say this. Memo to Tim Fincham, send a limo. Get him here as quick as possible.
Exactly.
Take a break. Tom James in the house. Time to go long. Lots of things to talk about, including those San Antonio Spurs. Coming up next right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're streaming live at WOCA.com.
The source.
Regions Bank has big bank ability but possesses small bank agility. Utilizing tools like Raymond Andrews and his team of six mortgage experts with 100 years of experience in the mortgage industry and 50 years experience as members of the Regions Bank team. Mortgage lending is personal and important, and you deserve someone that will lead you through a positive process. Raymond and his team use local mortgaging processes like local appraisers and local closing to help you have a positive experience, and they habla Espanol as well. So whether you need a conventional, FHA, USDA, or VA loan, or you even need a construction loan, the mortgage team of your local Regions Bank has the knowledge and experience to guide you through the process. So contact Raymond Andrews and his team of mortgage experts at 352-854-4104. That's 352-854-4104. Regions Bank, it's time to expect more. Recently, Buddy Martin was joined on Buddy Sports Page by the legendary Sports Illustrated writer Dan Jenkins.
Hey, you know, talking to young people, as you do a lot, and I do too, you know, I always tell them the first thing you do is show up. And you certainly did that from the time you went to, was it Katy Park, or you started going there and play with Hogan, and you showed up there, you showed up at the office, you began. That's how you got your job. You kept showing up, didn't you?
That's right. You got to show up. You got to let them know you exist, you know. People ask me, the only advice I have for any young people is just read everything you can get your hands on, especially read the people you might be able to learn something from, which is what I did. I declared John Lardner, anything he ever wrote, a Bible, same with Red Smith and a bunch of other people, but all you know is what you're going to learn, and if I developed a style of any kind, whatever, it was just taking from them and putting an edge on it and kind of, you know, finding your own voice somewhere along the way.
So remember, always check out Buddy Martin on the Voice of Ocala.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Yes, George.
Guess what I have?
Can it be the free truck used from Devin's Self-Storage on 200 across from Hobby Lobby?
You lie.
Yes. Now, don't forget to bring it back when you're done to Devin's Self-Storage.
Yes, Alice. I'll even remember to call them at 873-0777 to make sure they'll remember me.
George, I'm sure they'll remember you.
Thanks, Alice.
Oh, George.
Hey, Ocala, your friend Bob Wines has a real money-saving deal just in case your lawn needs some warm weather attention. It's famous Fertilome lawn fertilizer at a history-making low price. A big bag of Fertilome, enough to cover 5,000 square feet, regularly $19.99, just $6.99. That's right, just $6.99 for Fertilome, maximum care for your lawn. Check the other specials in this week's ad, like gorgeous dark red crepe myrtle, just $9.99. Buy one, get one free on a whole slew of famous name azaleas, and yes, you asked for it, a BOGO on many big trees delivered and planted in your yard. Now's the time to place Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens in Ocala, where this week's bargains are 5 acres big. Bob Wine's, close to everywhere, Southeast 38th Street, open Monday through Saturday, 9 to 5. Growing greener with Ocala since 1952.
Are you tired of not using your home's outdoor space for entertaining or relaxation because of all the bugs and leaves? Consider adding a beautiful screen room or glass enclosure. We are Superior Aluminum and Design, a family-owned and operated business with 20 years' experience in the aluminum industry, and we are accredited by the Better Business Bureau. If you appreciate superior workmanship, call Superior Aluminum and Design at 817-8058 or visit us on the web at superioraluminumdesign.com.
All day I faced a barren waste without the taste of water. Cool water.
There's the anthem for our program coming up now. Around the Water Cool on a Tuesday with Tom and Tom. I'm glad he didn't know how to turn his mic on yet. He's still working on that.
I may break that record.
We sabotaged his mic. So.
Exactly. Tom James joins us now for the program, as he does every Tuesday. How you doing, pal?
I'm good. It was a better time of the year to be a sports fan as far as your variety
a lot
than,
of stuff.
Than this.
No, stuff. I mean, you start with the last week in the Stanley Cup all the way through the U.S. Open. Now you got the World Cup. You got it all going on.
Baseball, everything.
Baseball, yeah. We talked a little bit about – you haven't had a chance to comment on this. Tom and I talked about it a lot yesterday. Tragic with Tony Gwynn. And, of course, several other people died over the weekend, too, including Larry Dupree, the former Gator running
former
back.
Former Gator, so. Yeah. I know you talked about that yesterday.
Yeah,
he was on Ray Graves' team.
Yes, he was. Early on, yeah. And country strong, country tough guy. Mm-hmm. Loved watching him play. But anyway, your thoughts on Tony Gwynn real quick before we get into
that. Well, I know that the cancer, tobacco was pointed to as believed to be the cause of all that. And a lot of that has changed in the culture of baseball. But I just know that one of the greatest stats I've ever heard is about Tony Gwynn. I believe his rookie year, he hit .289. The next 18 years, he hit over .300. 18 out of 18. Mm-hmm. So that tells you all you need to know about how great a hitter Tony Gwynn.
Talk about stats. If you like stats, you can't. He's got a bunch of them, including his lifetime average. Let's go now to Orlando. And the king of Local 6, our favorite sportscaster, David Pingelor, the great Pinkster. Hi, Dave.
Hey, boys. What's shaking today on this Tuesday?
Yeah, we're talking about the great Tony Gwynn. I'm sure you talked about it last night. I didn't get a chance to see your sportscast, but you know, when you put the numbers down there and you look at what's in front of you, I don't care if you want to go sabermetrics or otherwise, this guy was phenomenal. And I heard today Goose Gossage say something I made a comment on yesterday. Had he wanted to be a power hitter, he could have hit for power. But he hit for average, and he snapped it around the ballpark. He was really quite a scientist on hitting, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was. One of the great hitters in baseball. I mean, the guy, great and a nice guy. I mean, just everything you read and just, you know, over the years, not just after his passing, but he's always been held in high regard off the field as well. But certainly one of the best hitters ever. And but, gosh, just a young age at 54. Crazy.
I wasn't aware he was that bad off. I know he'd had some surgery, but I had no idea. Caught me by surprise, didn't you?
Yes, I did not know. I had read that he was battling cancer, yeah. and I guess it started from, chewing tobacco is from what I kind of read. So,
yeah.
And then we kind of got into a newsroom discussion. It's amazing how players nowadays, they don't you don't see that like it used to 30 years ago.
It used to be everywhere. And by the way, I know you're late getting here because you were riveted to the screen watching Mexico and Brazil. You couldn't get. You couldn't.
Oh yeah, I was riveted to that soccer match. Come on,
exciting yesterday.
Fifth highest market in the country for watching the U.S. game yesterday.
Was it? I know. I saw the top 10 markets before it started, and Orlando was number 10 then. So
yeah,
pretty cool. So you got a bunch of soccer guys down. You better start talking soccer, David. I know you do some. You talk about it some.
Well, you got the Orlando City Lions who go to Major League Soccer next year, and they've really taken, I guess, you know, they're kind of going to be a big deal in this town. Everywhere you're driving here in Orlando, there are billboards everywhere getting ready for MLS. So.
Yeah. Do you think we've heard this story now? All of us. Oh, there you go. Tom has this. He found this toy. Tom Schmitz did with the rim shot, you know, so he wants to play
with
it.
I'm just saying that, that was a good joke, soccer being legitimate.
So the point is that
– I mean, I agree with you, Tom. I don't watch soccer, so.
Well, but, I mean, here's the deal. It's real. And I don't think we know, really. I don't think we get it. I don't have an accurate gauge on it. I know it's getting more popular, Tom James, than what it used to be. And I know David's in the middle of it now with this Major League Soccer team. I can't – can you really gauge it, Dave?
Well, here's what it is and what I was told about soccer. The diehard and the true soccer fan is 35 and under.
Yeah.
Okay, anybody 35, 40 and older, they don't care.
Yeah.
And that's not the difference. I mean, so if soccer is getting big, we're saying this 20 years ago, those were the kids that were 5, 20 years ago or 10 playing it. More than I was playing it when I was, you know, a kid. I'm 42 now, so I didn't play soccer. You know, we played baseball. So I was 35 and younger is the audience that loves soccer. And that's who in our country, and that's who played it. So if you go back 20 years ago, you know, the 12-year-old kid who's 32 now, he's right, and he played soccer.
Soccer players are kids that got cut from the football team.
No,
but Ping, don't you think part of it is you can also point to ethnic diversity and the ever-increasing Latino population in this country where soccer is king. I think that also can kind of trigger those numbers a little bit too.
I think you're right, and I think, you know, Orlando has grown into that diversity, so I think that's why it's very popular here. You know, it's funny, Tom, like we joke about soccer and you're right, but you know, I was watching the game yesterday and again, I don't watch soccer. I mean, like I fully admit I don't sit there and watch soccer, but I go, yeah, who watches soccer? Look at how boring this is. They're just kind of like in the middle of the field, kicking the ball around. And I go, you know what? I remember I was in London last year with the Jags and sitting next to some English, you know, fans that don't watch regular, you know, American football. They go, this is like really boring. And if you look at football like that, football is really boring in a way because, I mean, how many first downs, you know, they run first and they get 2 yards and they got second and eight. I mean, that's kind of boring if you're not used to that. So soccer is really the same way. You know, they're dribbling around the middle of the field. It's like, what are they doing?
I'll tell you what it is. It is easier for women to understand than football. If the women who don't know football, you try to explain to them, and I say that, I know it sounds sexist, but it's true. You know, they can't follow the ball. They don't know where to watch. The players got too much gear on. At least they can see what's happening on the soccer matches. Although, you're right. There's a time, if you're watching Woody Hayes at Ohio State and watching today Mexico and Brazil, there's a similarity there, you know, 3 hours in a cloud of dust, right?
I mean, so it's kind of, you know, watching soccer, look, if you watch football, I mean, DirecTV does it in the fall when their NFL Sunday Ticket, they will cut down a football game to 30 minutes. They'll just edit like the plays. There's a lot of like, you know, get up, get back into the huddle. I mean, it's just, football is really just made for television. American football is a great TV sport.
Talk with Dave Pingelor, Local 6. Dave, let's talk about American football real quick. The Joe Namath of this era of football about to take the field, Johnny Manziel, signs today his rookie contract. That is this Johnny football saying it's time to play football? I signed on the dotted line. Let's go.
Yeah, I mean, of course he was going to sign. I mean, all these rookie deals are pretty much negotiated anyway with this new CBA, so you know he's going to sign. And, You know, it'll make for an exciting NFL start to the season anyway, with Johnny Football around, and see how it goes with him. And we've here in Florida have been privy to many Johnny Football games because of SEC. You know, the guy in Ohio didn't really probably watch a lot of Johnny Football. I mean, I've worked in Ohio, worked in Pennsylvania. When you live up there, I mean, I know the CBS game of the week is, you know, an SEC game, and you saw a lot of A&M, but those people were watching, you know, Big Ten football at 3:30. So Johnny Football will be kind of exciting just to see, because he's a smaller guy. It'll just be if he can overcome some odds.
Yeah. Real quick, I got one more for you. You may have seen a story. Urban Meyer has come out and said the 2008 Gators were the best football team ever. Have you seen that story?
I have seen that.
And your thoughts about it?
Well, you can make the argument. Why not? I mean, you have Percy Harvin. I mean, he had a lot of NFL talent on that team.
Yes, he did.
I mean, they're pretty good. I mean, if you go down their roster,
they dominated after losing that Mississippi game. They dominated a lot of the good teams there. I would not put them number one in my book. I still go back to that and the Johnny Rogers Nebraska team and Ellie the Nebraska game that crushed Florida. You know, as well. So those are two
Tommy Frazier Nebraska team.
That's with Frazier you're right. Talking about back in '95.
That's the undefeated team they hammered right there.
I can still have, as you bring that game up, I can still see Tommy. Is Tommy Frazier still running down the sideline?
Exactly. He may be running right now.
I mean, you remember that run? That's the one run I do remember.
You know, and one more quickie. We got 30 seconds. If you think about this. Steve Spurrier's Florida team played the number one team in the country in the Sugar Bowl and trounced them 52-20. That 96 team wasn't chopped liver either.
No, I mean, oh, man, those Spurrier teams were good, man. They were. Yeah.
All right, man, give me 5 seconds on the Spurs. Spurs going to win it again next year?
No.
Okay.
No, they're too old. Duncan may not even come back. The Magic won't win it for 50. The Magic will never win it.
Yeah,
I mean,
you're
really?
A lifetime, exactly.
I mean, hey, come on.
All right, David, listen, we're watching you tonight. Thanks for being on the show. We'll talk to you next Tuesday if you're around, all right?
All right, I'll be around.
Thank you, David. David Pingelor coming up next. It's time to go long with the boys here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA.
The Souls.
If you know what happiness means to you, because I'm happy that alone, if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Hey, Eddie, I'm playing Augusta in a few hours, and I need a fourth. Want to join us?
Georgia's close, but it's not that close, Alex.
Not Georgia. Golden Ocala. I'm a member at Golden Ocala, and this course has 8 tribute holes, like number 12 and 13. You know, part of Amen Corner and the postage stamp and the road hole. It's a phenomenal track. My family and I always have a great time at the pool and at the restaurants. They've got 3, you know. The kids love the tennis programs. My wife practically lives at the spa, and I've been bulking up with a personal trainer in their fitness center. Joining Golden Ocala was one of the best decisions I've ever made, aside from marrying my wife, of course. So you want to join us in a few hours?
Absolutely. I can't wait to play the first hole in golf and the road hole too. Hey, how do I become a member at Golden Ocala?
Eddie, just call 352-402-4343.
Luxury and great golf is affordable at Golden Ocala. Call 352-402-4343 to join.
This is Allison Campbell from the ARC Marion Foundation. Whenever I need the most up-to-date news on sports, Buddy Martin's sports page is where I go. Around the water cooler. Sometimes I even tell him myself.
Hello, everybody. This is Terry Bradshaw, Fox NFL Sunday. Whenever I'm in Ocala, if I'm not singing and singing with my buddy Mel Tillis, then I'm listening to my longtime friend Buddy Martin on WOCA. Of course, I rarely get to Ocala, so if you believe that, I've got some horses I'd like to sell you. Some of them even have 4 legs. Regardless, I highly recommend you listen to Buddy Martin's Sports Page weekdays at 5 p.m. right here on The Source.
Hi, I'm Buddy Martin, the host of The Voice of Ocala, every weekday from 3 to 6 right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. A lot of people ask me, how do you keep a muzzle on Tom Schmitz? Forget about it.
WOCA.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler, a suspect in custody for the Benghazi consulate attack that killed four Americans. Ahmed Abu Katala, a local leader of the militant group Ansar al-Sharia.
Sunday, when he was grabbed south of Benghazi by the U.S. Special Operations Team, he was taken to a U.S. Navy vessel in international waters. That's where he was held in those initial hours and initial days. We understand that he is still on board that ship. The Pentagon will not tell us the name of the vessel, but it is in international waters.
Fox's Jennifer Griffin, Nebraska's governor, calling this tornado damage the worst he's ever seen. Two giant side-by-side twisters slamming into the town of Pilger Monday, killing two.
The southeast corner of this town, about 20 homes are still standing, and that's really about it.
Fox's Mike Tobin, the Dow closing up 27, the NASDAQ gained 16. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At Termbusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call Termbusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Bond, Mike Bond. He's an award-winning poet and a human rights correspondent, and he's with the BBC, coming on to speak to us about his book, House of Jaguar. It's a thriller novel based on Mike Bond's own experiences in Guatemala.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Brad Nimmo will be in the studio. He's the president and CEO of Habitat for Humanity of Marion County. He's coming in with Sarah Isaacs. They'll be talking to us about the Mud Volleyball Tournament Bump, Set, and Build fundraising event.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Harlem Globetrotter Buckets Blakes is coming on the air with us, celebrating the 89th consecutive year of the Harlem Globetrotters.
Jay Scott is the co-executive director of Alex's Lemonade Stand Foundation. He'll be speaking about the foundation dedicated to finding a cure for childhood cancer.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
When you kiss somebody for the first time, you subconsciously decipher a whole host of information about their health and your compatibility. Workers who scheduled a day off every few weeks saw their productivity increase to fresh off their vacation levels. Turns out, just seeing a strong-willed person stick to their goals, even in the face of temptation, increases your own motivation.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
All day I faced a barren waste without the taste of water. Cool water.
All right, enough of that.
You're right, Guy. I agree with you. You're good.
By the way, I mentioned this earlier, and it's been around for a couple of days, but I'll get you guys' take on this. I haven't done an inventory of teams in my mind. I have some go back to. We mentioned a couple. But Urban Meyer's statement, that the speech he made, says, I think the best team ever to play the game was – wait a minute. Let me say this again. I've been a part of a couple of great teams. He says, I think the best team to ever play the game in 08 was at Florida, and that was because the animal instincts took over on the field. They protected each other, he said. which is kind of weird. But he says, what he said was, have you ever tried to reason with a wild animal? Think about that. Think about what I just said. You try to reason with a wild animal. I don't think the image, that's the image they want at Ohio State of their football players right now. But
what about that 1989 undefeated team at Georgia South? Oh, wait. Yeah. Never mind.
So anyway, the 2018 was 13-1. They did lose to Mississippi. And Tim Tebow, of course, was the centerpiece of that. I don't think he's – I mean, you make a case, as Dave Pinglor said, but I don't think I put him at the top of my list, and I love that team, by the way. So,
Buddy, I've got five – this I'll do this in my lifetime, and I'm 42. Here are the five best teams in my mind of my lifetime.
So USC's on this list somewhere.
I'll go the 79 –
Okanu Rockney or
– No, I don't go back that far, but I'll go the 79 Alabama team. The 83 Nebraska team that did not win the national championship, the 01 Miami team, the 04 USC team, and the 08 Florida team. Those are the five best to me in my lifetime.
See, and the three best to me in my lifetime were the 1980 Georgia Bulldogs that had Herschel Walker and the junkyard defense that held a Notre Dame team that averaged 31 points a game to 7 points when Larry Munson said, it's raining sugar from the sky. the 0-1 Miami team, the Georgia team in 80, and the Nebraska team in 05, both were great football teams. But the best football team for my money ever in college football was the 0-1 Miami team. That 0-1 Miami team was an NFL football team. That team could have went and played the NFL and beat some teams. Because, they all did go to the NFL and play.
Well, that's the team that took apart Nebraska out, I believe, in the Fiesta Bowl. Actually, it was in the Rose Bowl.
Right, the Rose Bowl.
In the Rose Bowl for the national title. But of the five that I put in there, one of those five did not win at all, and that's that 83 Nebraska team.
That lost to Miami.
31-30. I still think that Nebraska team, in terms of its makeup, is one of the five for me.
I'd have a hard time putting any Nebraska team above the 95 Huskers and Tommy Frazier and the Johnny Rogers team in 1972,
mm-hmm.
the Nebraska-Oklahoma game. They were a fabulous football team. Probably a little for your time, but they were great.
And you know what kills what gets me right here? None of us, because it was before my time, before your time, Tom. Buddy was a young man, a young kid then, I think.
Yeah.
We forget that Oklahoma still holds the record for 48 wins in a row without losing a football game.
With the Bud Wilkinson games, when Bud Wilkinson was the head coach.
Yeah. Those Oklahoma football teams did win 48 games in a row.
Yep, in the 50s.
That's a good point. But the problem is it's not the era. It's the season we're talking about.
Right.
One team. And you could make a case for several teams.
Well, that team won four and a half years in a row without losing.
Fantastic. It's a fantastic. Was it Notre Dame that beat them?
Notre Dame beat them.
Is it a fantastic run? But in terms of a team and a season or whatever, 08 would probably be in the top five or six, whatever, of Gators. But that Nebraska team, I mean,
they dismantled Florida.
That was an undefeated Florida team.
A good Florida football program.
Undefeated Florida team.
Yep. That was the 95 game.
And an old Southern proverb, they beat the brakes off of them.
Yeah, they did. Buddy, real quick, isn't it interesting that you said that the long Oklahoma winning streak in college football, which is the longest of all time, mm-hmm. was that winning streak snapped by Notre Dame, who also is the school that snapped UCLA's
88-game
winning streak, the longest ever in college basketball.
So. Right.
Yeah. It's,
wow, I did know that.
there it is. I went early.
Wrong segment. All right, speaking of Gator football, it's time to go along, and mine today is on the misfortune of being Will. I've thought about this a long time before I wrote this column. It's now on southernpickscene.com, but here's the point. Very, very unlucky guy, and perhaps some of this is self-inflicted, but here's what I wrote. Will Muschamp won the Powerball last week, but his dog ate the winning ticket. Will Muschamp stepped around a black cat in a ladder on Friday the 13th, slipped and fell into a car, cracking the side of the mirror, and said, I wonder if he'll count last year and a half toward time served for good behavior. Because for the last 18 months, he's had some unfortunate things happen. Neither one of those things actually happened to Muschamp. The way his luck has been going the last year and a half, I fully expect to hear any day he was out playing golf by himself and scored his first hole-in-one with nobody there to witness it. Happened to a friend of mine, as a matter of fact. We've seen this comic book character before in Little Abner, who walks around with a black cloud over his head. Joe, I could never pronounce this, Bispilk, brings misfortune to everybody around him. Later on, Al Capp, the cartoonist, had him produce Miraculous Rescues, which Will Muschamp can only hope could happen for him. But these are not the best of times for Florida's 42-year-old coach, now approaching his fourth season in semi-limbo. Aside from the football issues, he had Father's Day to endure on Sunday. His dad, Larry, who would have been 80 last week, died of a heart attack May 1st. The same dad who taught him the axiom, 10% of life is what happens to you, 90% is what you do with it. It remains to be seen what Will is going to do with the rest of the 90% from his recent streak of misfortune. Yet another mishap befell Muschamp last week when his wide receiver coach was forced to resign over what appears to have been a recruiting violation by Joker Phillips. We can only see apparently because University of Florida won't fess up. But what's next? His student manager is a serial killer?
Wow. You know, you can't disagree with any of that except for you say that he's had a bunch of bad luck. I would say almost all of it is his own doing.
Yeah. A different coach had a serial killer on his team, but
yeah.
Hit the rim shot there.
I missed it. Sorry.
No. At least a murderer, we know that for sure.
Yeah. Thank you. Wow.
I would say that Muschamp is almost, and you know I've not been a big fan of Muschamp's recently, especially, almost a sympathetic figure. What do you guys think?
You know, I can't agree with that because I think he brings most of the bad things that happen to us. His childlike ways on the sideline and the way he screams and yells. I mean, I have a photo of him where he looks like Mean Mug Magoo staring down a referee in his first year because he's a crazy man.
You might see it on my Facebook page right now, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
But the bottom line is that he didn't break the leg of his quarterback. Okay, you got what I'm saying? That didn't happen because of poor coaching.
But buddy, it's hard for me when you have a losing streak as long as they had to blame it on, you know, that injury or a couple of other ones. When you have recruiting classes like they have, it's hard for those excuses to kind of hold a lot of water.
So you're taking my position on this.
A little bit.
This is what I've been saying. But now I'm trying to go back and be honest about it, drill down on it and say, let's take another look. Can he turn it around? What if he wins 8 games, 9 games this year? Do I think he will? No. But I'm just saying, I'm trying to look at this differently. So, like I said, the misfortune of being Will Muschamp.
It wasn't a misfortune that a Division I school with 85 scholarships, injuries or not, lost to a school that they had no business even playing close to. And I make all the jokes, and I like to rub it in that Georgia Southern won. But to be honest, Georgia Southern had no business in that football game to be able to win it at the end.
It's still the misfortune, unfortunately. Okay, Tom, what you got? You want to talk NBA?
I do. The 2013-2014 NBA season has come to a close. San Antonio Spurs, led by their captain Tim Duncan, defeated LeBron James and the Miami Heat 4-1. To claim the NBA title. This is the fifth title of Duncan's career. That number immediately reminded me of another NBA superstar with 5 rings, Kobe Bryant. Then this silly question popped in my head. Is this the Kobe Bryant era of the NBA or the Tim Duncan era of the NBA? See, I told you it was a silly question. Or is it? Duncan and Bryant have both been in the league almost the same exact amount of time. Kobe was a rookie in 96, Duncan a rookie in 97. Duncan made the all-rookie first team, Bryant made the all-rookie second team. Kobe has made the all-NBA first team 11 times, Duncan has made the all-NBA first team 10 times. Tim Duncan has 2 NBA Most Valuable Player awards, Kobe only has 1. Duncan has 3 NBA Final MVP awards. Bryant only has 2 Finals MVPs. Kobe does have 2 Olympic gold medals to Tim's 1 Olympic bronze. But hey, basketball ain't what it used to be in the Virgin Islands. And during the 2004 Olympics, it wasn't really that much in the United States either. Tim Duncan has shown the ability to play the game of basketball with a myriad of different players, from David Robinson, Avery Johnson, Manu Ginobili, to Tony Parker. Kobe Bryant has shown the ability to have players and coaches removed from the Lakers, most notably one of the five greatest centers to ever play in the NBA, Shaquille O'Neal. Tim Duncan has achieved greatness without asking for, receiving, or needing the hype that is today's NBA. Kobe Bryant doesn't know how to exist without it. In today's NBA, flash and bravado are what sells jerseys and makes ESPN highlight reels. That screams Kobe Bryant. But when the question of whose era of the NBA is it, and the choices are Kobe Bryant or Tim Duncan, I look at numbers first. As I've shown you, they're pretty close when it comes to hardware at the end of seasons. So then I refer to character. And in that category, in my opinion, is it even close? Duncan wins in a landslide. So next time somebody says this is Kobe's era, remind them it may not be the slam dunk they'd like it to be.
All right, thank you very much. Good night, Tom. We haven't got time for you to respond after that.
That's probably a good thing.
We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll give Tom James his say after this on Buddy Martin Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of the Properties Salon in downtown Ocala. Here in Florida, we're all about summertime fun, but along with the warm weather comes humidity, which leads to the dreaded frizzies. Are you tired of checking the weather report every morning before deciding to flat iron your hair? Sick of looking like the Lion King every day by noon? Has God just not seen fit to answer your prayers for patience and silky, frizz-free hair? Well, your troubles are over. Come to the Properties Salon for one of our hair smoothing systems. Specializing in Peter Coppola and Cezanne keratin smoothing treatments, the Properties Salon can tame your unruly locks with these formaldehyde-free formulas. And with the discount code BUDDYROCKS, you will save 20%. Not fighting the frizzies? Mention the same code BUDDYROCKS to save 20% off one of our many services such as cuts, color extensions, and manis and pedis. Gentlemen, this special is not just for the ladies. We do great cuts and color for men too. Check us out at theproperties.com for more information.
Regions Bank has big bank ability but possesses small bank agility. Utilizing tools like Raymond Andrews and his team of six mortgage experts with 100 years of experience in the mortgage industry and 50 years experience as members of the Regions Bank team. Mortgage lending is personal and important, and you deserve someone that will lead you through a positive process. Raymond and his team use local mortgaging processes like local appraisers and local closing to help you have a positive experience, and they habla Espanol as well. So whether you need a conventional, FHA, USDA, or VA loan, or you even need a construction loan, the mortgage team of your local Regions Bank has the knowledge and experience to guide you through the process. So contact Raymond Andrews and his team of mortgage experts at 352-854-4104. That's 352-854-4104. Regions Bank, it's time to expect more.
Look who just walked in the room, Joe Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joe, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joe, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah. Whatsupocala.com.
Coming August 8th and 9th, the first annual Ocala Bike Fest. How would you like a chance to win a 2014 Harley Street Glide? How about a 2014 Indian Chief Vintage? The tickets are only $100 each, and each chance drawing has only 599 tickets. Now that is some great odds. All proceeds go to ARC. Questions, call 387-2210. The number again is 387-2210. Ocala Bike Fest. We'll see you there.
Cookies, 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 cookies.
When cookies, you want something special and fun for any occasion, get cookies. That's right. The Great American Cookie Company in the Paddock Mall, Ocala, will make a delicious, fun-filled delight just for you. You might notice that I said fun and delicious more than once. That's because I can't say it enough. The next time you're at the mall, be sure and stop by or call 352-237-2557 to place your order.
Cookies, cookies,
yum.
Cookies, cookies. We go cookie eating cookies.
The Great American Cookie Company.
Keep up with what's going on in the downtown area with Ocala Downtown Newspaper. Delivering thousands of newspapers to businesses in the downtown area, Ocala Downtown is there to keep you informed. They even have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask in return is that you tell them where you heard about it. It's simple. For more info, just call Tom's Picks, 352-804-1223, and pick up your copy of the Downtown Ocala newspaper today.
Now read Ocala Downtown newspaper online.
All day I face.
Right, I think it's the Tony Parker era. Anyway, all right, Tom.
Touche.
Tom James, you want to give a quick response? If you don't, go ahead with your go long.
Well, that was well prepared, Schmitty. Great job on the Tim Duncan thing. I obviously. I'm a Kobe guy, and I do disagree with some of the things you said, but you certainly were pretty well researched on that in the span of time in which Tim Duncan won those titles from beginning to end is pretty impressive.
Oh, I think it's Kobe era. It's just not the slam dunk everybody thinks it is.
On the go long, Tom James.
All right. This is about the changing tides of sports popularity in this country. America lives in a day and age when no longer do we have a large group of popular major sports. The millennium has taken us to a place in this country where all sports have been thinly spread out to niche status in popularity, with only one remaining exception, the behemoth that is football. We've seen days go by when baseball was America's pastime. Boxing and horse racing events completely stopped the clocks. More recently, we had tennis boom in the late 70s and early 80s, basketball in the 80s and 90s, and when Tiger landed, golf ratings soared. But today, football is the last sport standing that is universally loved across the generations, ethnicity, gender, rich or poor, and geography. The answer to the question, why has this happened, is pretty simple to me. The sports landscape has changed because our culture has changed. Too many other things to do these days. You never used to be able to watch movies at home. No computers, no cell phones, and no ESPN and cable. When a sporting event was on TV, it was special. Now, it's diluted. It's too convenient. You always know that if you miss tonight's game, you can catch the next one on any given evening. And people's lives are too distracted with more gadgets and endless sources of entertainment, creating a dizzying menu of options. We've become Generation ADD. Not to say that options are bad, they just tend to spread the popularity of things more horizontally than vertically. And so for the masses that work hard on the weekdays and raise kids in the evening, there's just one sport out there that is a unifier, the one that Saturdays and Sundays were made for, and that is football.
Well said. And to your point, by the way, this along with, I did not know that, and maybe we'll have time for Tom Spencer, right what you just said. Listen to this. In March, for the first time in the 20-year history of ESPN Sports Poll, Major League Soccer caught up with Major League Baseball as being equally popular among 12 to 17-year-olds. In 2012, the poll found that among 12 to 24-year-olds, soccer was ranked second most popular sport after football, ahead of not just baseball and basketball, but college football and hockey. Meanwhile, participation in all major groups of sports has dropped or stayed the same since 2008, with one exception, soccer.
Soccer. Yep.
There you go. The numbers don't lie. All right, Tom.
Wow.
Stat.
I did not know that.
Give us that stat real fast on Tony Gwynn.
Tony Gwynn passed yesterday. I found this interesting. In his 20-year career, Tony Gwynn compiled more plate appearances versus Greg Maddux than any other pitcher he faced. He faced him 107 times. Not once did Tony Gwynn strike out against Greg Maddux.
Amazing stat. Guy only had one game with three or more strikeouts. And
that's an amazing stat.
Yeah. Wow.
Wow.
I did not know that.
All right. Very good, gentlemen. Good job today. And I want to thank Dave Pingalore, who joins us on Tuesdays.
I want to thank Joe Martone this afternoon.
Joe Martone, on behalf of my broadcast partner, Tom Spence, and Tom James, and Christian Comas, who's telling Jocker jokes. I'm Buddy Martin. Have a great night, everybody. She grew
It's the ultimate summer staycation, just minutes from downtown Ocala, but miles away from the ordinary. A summer sports or summer golf membership at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club is your all-inclusive ticket to a summer filled with activities and fun from June through September. A summer membership at Golden Ocala opens the door to a world-class setting. Is golf your game? Is tennis your passion? Or is lounging poolside more your speed? Want to get in shape? Work out in the state-of-the-art fitness center and then relax and unwind in the sauna or the spa. Summer members also have use of the equestrian center at Golden Ocala, offering full board and paddock, impeccable trails, and a jumping ring for riders of all ages. Summer memberships are going fast. So visit goldenocala.com and explore the options. Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. This summer, you can live there and still play here.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
Are you in the process of planning your wedding reception? Or are you planning that birthday party for someone special? Or maybe you're just looking to throw a party for yourself. Are you in charge of this year's company outing and looking for something fresh and fun to do? Well, KT Entertainment is your answer to all those questions. We provide music, trivia, and karaoke for everybody's enjoyment. If you would like to get in touch with KT Entertainment and find out about our competitive prices, call us at 352-512-2611. That's 352-512-2611. Or you can find us on the web at kt4fun.com. That's KT, the number 4, fun.com. So remember, whether it's a wedding reception, a party, or a company outing, it's KT Entertainment for all your karaoke, trivia, or musical needs.
Garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Howdy, folks. RL here to invite you to DQ. Dairy Queen is serving the crispiest, juiciest, most tasty chicken tenders, all beef chili dogs, and quarter pound cheeseburgers on earth. And you get crispy fries, a drink, and an ice cream sundae of your choice for only $5. Remember, at DQ, you can lick their cones, but you can't beat their shakes. Dairy Queen, Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's OcalaForSale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less proofing factory surcharge or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
WOCA.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler. After a Sunday special ops raid, a suspect in custody for the deadly Benghazi consulate attack.
Ahmed Abdul-Katala faces prosecution in the United States for allegedly helping plan the 2012 terror attack. The notorious Islamist commander faces three counts in a federal complaint against him, filed in the U.S. District Court in the District of Columbia.
Fox Radio's Rachel Sutherland. The National Weather Service says one of the tornadoes that tore through the town of Pilger, Nebraska Monday, killing two, was likely a powerful EF4.
Everything that made this little town a town, Main Street, the bank, the school, the coffee shop, took a direct hit.
Fox's Mike Tobin, a wildfire north of Bakersfield, California, now 75% contained. Another fire threatening two Native American communities near the Arizona-New Mexico state line. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Policies issued by American General Life Insurance Company, Houston, Texas. Not available in all states. For details, visit AIGdirect.com.
I stopped seeing life insurance as something only rich people needed after my brother-in-law died. On top of really missing him, I watched my sister struggle to keep up with their mortgage, car payments, and everyday living expenses for her and the kids. I realized then that life insurance isn't just for millionaires. It's for anyone who has people in their lives who depend on them to get by. It's to help everyday people help protect their families. People like me. So I called AIG Direct. And I was shocked at how affordable coverage can be. Just $14 a month for $250,000 of term life coverage. I may not have $1 million, but my family's well-being and happiness is priceless. I'm glad I have AIG Direct to help protect their future, no matter what happens to me.
Call AIG Direct right now for a free, no-obligation quote. The call takes less than 5 minutes, and you can save up to 70%. Call now, 1-800-895-2949. That's 1-800-895-2949. 1-800-895-29.
Who would you feed if you had 50 chicken sandwiches from Chick-fil-A? WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall have teamed up to reward one organization with 50 chicken sandwiches as a way of saying thanks for the great work that organization is doing in our community. And we need your help. See, there are so many great people doing great things that we need nominations. You can nominate your own organization or any organization you choose. Simply send an email to WOCA@WOCA.com. And in 350 words or less, tell us why the organization you are nominating should receive 50 free chicken sandwiches from WOCA and Chick-fil-A at the Paddock Mall. We'll review your nominations and then select one deserving organization each month. We'll announce the winner and even read the winning entry on the air. Make sure